So whatever you do, whatever the syllabus you study, whatever topic, whatever book you study, always study it for civil services exam. I know the temptation is there ki bahut maza aa raha hai. All right, you are studying so many new things. It is good you are taking interest, but try to limit yourself. Because in this exam, there is no end of knowledge. Vaise bhi there is no end of knowledge. But especially for this exam, there is so much, there are so many books, so much data is there. So you may get lost. So always try to stick to the syllabus, stick to the questions. Complete the syllabus first. Uske baad koi interesting book agar mil rahi hai, maan lo, do teen din ka gap hai, you want to unwind, so you can take up that book. But always study for this exam, whatever you do. Right? Now modern Indian history portion, many of you who may have attended the open session, its weightage is considerable for the history portion, especially for prelims. In the prelims, for the history portion, there are four parts. Culture, ancient, medieval, and modern Indian history. Of these four, this is the most important portion. And the easiest to master also, right? Isse kafi questions aa rahe hain, and it is very well defined. All right, so it can be easily mastered. These three are the most vague. In the open session also I told that there are traditionally four pillars. Geography, yesterday you had a class. Then MIH is there. Then your economics is there. Polity is there. These are the four traditional pillars for prelims. If you master them, 90% chance you will clear the prelims. If you will master them. Master matlab ki aaya hai toh 90% accuracy ke saath karna hai usse. That should be the level of accuracy. After that, culture aur wo baki do cheezein, science and tech, environment. Right? These are three vague things. Thoda inko master karna, it is a bit difficult. Right? तो our strategy should be के इन चार को तो अच्छे से घोटा लगा लो ताकि इसमें से जो क्वेश्चन है वो ना निकल के जाए फिर राइट एंड इनको प्रिपेयर टू दैट एक्सटेंट सो दैट ईजी टू मीडियम लेवल क्वेश्चंस विल नॉट वी विल नॉट फॉल्टर इन देम डिफिकल्ट आएगा तो सबके लिए डिफिकल्ट है उसको मास्टर करने के चक्कर में सब कुछ टाटरी हो जाए वो भी इट इज़ नॉट अ गुड डिसीजन स्ट्रैटेजी बाकी सब पे ध्यान ना दे पाओ सो आर स्ट्रैटेजी शुड बी इन चारों को मास्टर करना है एंड इन दीज थ्री थिंग्स दिस शुड बी नंबर वन दीज टू आर कंबाइंड नंबर टू बिकॉज देर इज अ लॉट ऑफ ओवरलैप एंशियंट में आप देखोगे मौर्य एज गुप्ता एज दे आर ग्रेट देवर ग्रेट पैटर्नाइजर्स फॉर आर्ट आर्किटेक्चर तो वो सब चीज़ें कल्चर में वैसी आ जाती हैं तो दीज टू थिंग्स आर ओवरलैप मेडिवल को लास्ट में देख लेना टाइम मिलेगा तो उसे देख लेना एटलीस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट चीज़ें भक्ति भक्ति उसमें से कर लो सो दैट शुड बी अ स्ट्रैटेजी राइट I will be taking this portion, modern Indian history. Got it? Pure overall context mein mara, we are going for prelims right now. Prelims ka focus jyada ho gaya GS1 pe because GS2 has become qualifying. Ab usme 33% number chahiye, 33% is nothing. You can get easily, but still usme bhi karke chale jana, 4-5 paper to lagai jana. Wahan jaake surprise mat ho jana because in mains also there is English Hindi. उसमें भी लेकिन लोग रह जाते हैं फॉर हर काइंड इन्फॉर्मेशन दो आर देर वी ईजी एग्जाम्स सो नेवर टेक डोंट टेक एनीथिंग लाइटली तो इन द ओवरऑल कंटेक्स्ट ऑफ प्रिलिम्स दीज आर द फोर थिंग्स दीज आर द वेग थिंग्स एंड दिस इज आर एरिया ऑफ कंसर्न MIH मॉडर्न इंडियन हिस्ट्री राइट वी मस्ट ऑलवेज बी वेरी प्रिसाइज वॉट इज आर एरिया ऑफ कंसर्न नाउ वॉट एवर वील कवर फॉर प्रिलिम्स मेनी ऑफ द थिंग्स विल बी ऑटोमेटिकली कवर्ड फॉर मेन्स ऑल्सो होना भी ऐसा ही चाहिए देर आर नो साइलोज फॉर प्रिलिम्स इन मेन्स स्पेशली फॉर दीज थिंग्स बट मेन्स में डिफरेंस क्या है कि MIH में इन प्रिलिम्स दे में आस्क यू कि व्हाट वाज़ द फीचर ऑफ 1919 एक्ट इन MIH देर आर मेनी थीम्स सो वन थीम इज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल डेवलपमेंट तो राइट फ्रॉम 1773 रेगुलेटिंग एक्ट हम पूरा देखेंगे 1935 तक कैसे एक्ट बन रहा है पूरा इंडिया का और फिर बाद में हमारा पोस्ट इंडिपेंडेंस में भी इट विल कम कि वॉट आर हाउ आर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन वॉज फ्रेम्ड तो So in the prelims, they may just ask you ki in 1990 NAT, what was the unique thing? They'll give you four options. We have to choose between them. That is the scope of prelims. But in mains, they will ask you questions how the Act of 1935 provided the necessary experience to our constitutional founders, framers, to frame the constitution in record time. So you see the difference. The difference is ki prelims mein they are just separating the serious candidates from non-serious. Jo serious hoga usko at least itna to pata hi hoga usko ki bhai 1919 mein kya tha important ya 1909 mein kya important tha ya swadeshi kyon hua tha, why swadeshi petered out, why quit India was launched. Ye basic cheezein to pata honi chahiye na serious candidates ko. So these things will be tested at prelims. Wahan se fir jo non-serious ko ghar bhej denge aur fir serious wale aage mains mein jayenge. And there also those who have mastered answer writing, वो फिर आगे जाएंगे, ठीक है? This should be our focus for prelims. Got it? History we are studying for this exam, but otherwise also we must know precisely what our history is, because nowadays a lot of political debates are going on. तो many a times facts are being distorted. किसी को बदनामी कर रहे हैं कि नेहरू ऐसे करता था, गांधी जी ऐसे करते थे, और इंडिपेंडेंस के टाइम ये धोखा हो गया, वो हो गया. तो यू मस्ट नो द करेक्ट हिस्ट्री दैट व्हाट वाज द स्ट्रेटजी ऑफ गांधी जी, हाउ आवर इंडिपेंडेंस वाज, हाउ डिड वी गेट आवर इंडिपेंडेंस. कोई लोग कहते हैं कि मुगल हमें पहले राज किए 800 साल, फिर अंग्रेज राज किए 200 साल. दीज काइंड ऑफ थ्योरीज आर देयर, बट मुगल्स वर बेसिकली इंडियंस ओनली, लेटर ऑन दे बिकेम इंडियंस ओनली. और राज किया हम पे इज इम्प्लिसिट कि हम कुछ है. वॉज देयर एन इंडिया इन द फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल? देयर वॉज नॉट ओनली अ स्ट्रगल फॉर इंडिपेंडेंस, देयर वॉज ऑल्सो अ नेशन बिल्डिंग प्रोसेस. नेशन भी नहीं थे ना पहले तो. पहले तो प्रिंसली स्टेट से आपस में लड़ रहे हैं. यू मस्ट नो दैट इन थर्ड बैटल ऑफ पानीपत 1761, नवाब ऑफ अवध फेवर्ड द अब्दालीज अगेंस्ट द मराठास. तो कहाँ है नेशन? वेयर इज द नेशन? यू आर टॉकिंग कि हमें ब्रिटिशर्स ने कर लिया कैप्चर्ड. तो दैट वॉज ऑल्सो द प्रोसेस ऑफ फ्रीडम. तो ये चीज़ के लिए भी हमें हिस्ट्री पढ़नी चाहिए, सो दैट वी मे नॉट गेट गुमराह बाय द पीपल कि ये हो रहा है, वो हो रहा है, गांधी जी ने उससे अपीजमेंट की, मुसलमानों को किया. वी मस्ट नो द करेक्ट हिस्ट्री ऑफ अवर फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल एंड आवर नेशन, राइट? गॉट इट? सो दिस इज आवर ऑब्जेक्टिव, बट थोड़ा इमोशनल एंगल कम करेंगे और प्रीलिम्स के लिए ज़्यादा फोकस करेंगे. वी हैव गॉट अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम फॉर इमोशनल आस्पेक्ट्स ऑल्सो. वैन यू बिकम अ सिविल सर्वेंट, रीड मैनी बुक्स. यू विल हैव टू रीड मैनी बुक्स. ऑल राइट. So first of all, what I'll do is, I'll give you some sources. Kain se padh lena. There are many sources. I'll prescribe you some. First one is the class 12th old NCRT. Bipin Chandra is the author, along with others. Class 12th old NCRT. Then there is a book called India's Struggle for Independence by Bipin Chandra. Ye bhi ek bahut bada granth hai. Then there is a book called Spectrum Modern India. Basically it is these are notes only. Kisi ne taiyari ki thi, usne notes banaye hain, baad mein kitab nikal di. And then the fourth is Shekhar Bandopadhyay, Placer to Partition. These are the four books. In the open session also I talked ki kya karna chahiye strategy. My suggestion would be ke take Spectrum India, it is in the form of नोट्स, इट इज़ फैक्ट लेडन. स्टोरी थोड़ा सा अनक्लियर हो जाती है कभी कभी. सो वॉट यू कैन डू, यू कैन सप्लीमेंट इट बाई NCERT. इट इज़ अ फॉर्म ऑफ स्टोरी. सो दीज टू थिंग्स विल गो टूगेदर. अदरवाइज बिपिन चंद्र भी लोग पढ़ते हैं, बट आई विल नॉट प्रिस्क्राइब बिपिन चंद्र फॉर दिस एग्जाम. फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ अवर एग्जाम दीज टू सोर्सेज विल सफाइस. उसके बाद शेखर बंदोपाध्याय भी है, दैट इज ऑल्सो इन अ फॉर्म ऑफ स्टोरी. इट इज़ अ कंसाइज बुक. तो अगर आप चाहते हो, यू कैन रिप्लेस NCERT विद बंदोपाध्याय. दिस यू कैन डू, दिस इज योर चॉइस. कितने लोगों ने प्रीलिम्स दिया है पहले भी? ऑलराइट, सो मोस्ट ऑफ यू हैव गिवन द प्रीलिम्स बिफोर. व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम विद प्रीलिम्स इन मॉडर्न इंडियन हिस्ट्री? एनी प्रॉब्लम्स यू हैव विद मॉडर्न इंडियन हिस्ट्री, दोज हू हैव गिवन प्रीलिम्स? बिकॉज यू मस्ट हैव रेड बेसिक. बेसिक रीडिंग तो कर ही रखी है ना मॉडर्न इंडियन हिस्ट्री. Can't remember things. Okay. Trivial details. Are they on trivial details? ओके इन द ओपन सेशन आई शोड यू वन क्वेश्चन ऑन रॉलेट सत्याग्रह. उसमें देर वॉज वन स्टेटमेंट दैट रॉलेट एक्ट वॉज बेस्ड ऑन द रिकमेंडेशन ऑफ सेडिशन कमिटी. तो दैट इज अ ट्रिवियल फैक्ट, ही इज राइट. बट इन दैट क्वेश्चन इफ वी सी विदाउट द नॉलेज ऑफ दैट ट्रिवियल फैक्ट वी कुड सॉल्व दैट क्वेश्चन. अभी हम वर्कशीट्स भी सॉल्व करेंगे आफ्टर द लेक्चर, देर ऑल्सो विल सी के विदाउट ट्रिवियल फैक्ट्स ऑल्सो वी कैन सॉल्व. येस आई एग्री विद यू कि हो सकता है कुछ क्वेश्चन कभी कभी ट्रिवियल फैक्ट पे हो. बिकॉज दैट इज व्हाई आई एम सेइंग ना MIH इज द मोस्ट डिफाइंड, इट इज द पेट टॉपिक ऑफ द फोर हिस्ट्री टॉपिक्स. तो इसलिए उसको अच्छे से UPSC पूछ रही है, तो इसलिए हमें उसे अच्छे से करके जाना. नाउ हिज प्रॉब्लम इज के रिमेंबर नहीं होती चीज़ें. एनी अदर प्रॉब्लम? याद नहीं होती चीज़ें तो वैसे सबके लिए एक प्रॉब्लम है फॉर एवरी टॉपिक इन UPSC. एक जनरल एडवाइस आई विल गिव यू ऑन हाउ टू रिमेंबर थिंग्स इन दिस एग्जाम फॉर एवरीथिंग. वॉट एवर यू रीड उसको पढ़ो एक घंटे के लिए, चाहे वो अखबार है चाहे वो बुक है, वॉट एवर इट इज. आफ्टर वन आवर क्लोज डाउन द बुक और द न्यूज़पेपर एंड रिकॉल कि वॉट आई हैव स्टडीड. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू डू दिस प्रैक्टिस दिस एक्सरसाइज? ओके ही डज इट. तो क्या होता है इससे? यस एंड देर इज अ लॉट ऑफ प्रेशर ऑन द माइंड ऑल्सो. बहुत सर दुखता है कि कुछ याद नहीं आ रहा. ऑलराइट, तो दिस प्रैक्टिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली वॉट वी नीड टू डू ना, वी नीड टू डाइजेस्ट थिंग्स. हम इतना कुछ पढ़ रहे हैं, कल्चर पढ़ रहे हैं, साइंस, पहले तो कभी कुछ नहीं पढ़ा जिंदगी में, और 11वीं 12वीं में भी कुछ पढ़ा है. देन देर ऑल्सो वी स्टडीड वेरी सुपरफिशली. लेसन दिया है, आफ्टर द लेसन देर आर सेट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस एंड दोज क्वेश्चंस विल बी आस्क्ड इन द एग्जाम ऑल्सो एंड वी स्टडी द क्वेश्चंस ऑल्सो. राइट, आई हैव सिबलिंग्स ऑल्सो, दे आर हैविंग बोर्ड एग्जाम्स राइट नाउ. तो सो जो 7वीं 8वीं क्लास के हैं, तो दे आर नॉट रीडिंग द लेसन इवन, दे आर जस्ट मेमोराइजिंग द क्वेश्चंस, क्योंकि उन्हीं में से आएगा. सो दैट इज द काइंड ऑफ स्टडी वी आर डूइंग. एंड आफ्टर दैट व्हेन वी रीच 12th क्लास दे आस्क कि वी नाउ रिक्वायर एनालिटिकल थिंकिंग. पहले तो पढ़ाया नहीं एनालिटिकल, और अचानक 12वीं में ITJEE PMT दे आर आस्किंग एनालिटिकल थिंकिंग. देन वी कम टू UPSC अगेन दे आर आस्किंग एनालिटिकल. सो वी नाउ नीड टू ट्रेन आवर माइंड्स इन दैट डायरेक्शन. तो व्हेन यू रीड अ टॉपिक, फॉर एग्जांपल आज न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ा, close down the newspaper and recall what are the top four news items I have studied. So recall kya hai aaj ki news item, right? There was some news item regarding agriculture loans, those above 1 crore, government is saying we'll look into it. So like that recall things, then only they will stick in your mind, they'll remain, retain, you will able to retain them. Got it? Aur koi point hai, jaise maan lo 1773 act hai. There are 5 points. In every point, there will be one unique word that will define that point. Right? For example, maan lo, there is a question, what government has done for women? So there are 6 points. First says that government has launched Rashtra Mahila Kosh for easy credit. Second, jaise Sexual Harassment Act. Third, literacy ke liye kuch kar, ye aapka NRLM kar rakha hai, right? तो इन दीज 3 पॉइंट्स देर आर 3 कीवर्ड्स. फर्स्ट इज RMK, सेकेंड इज सेक्सुअल हरासमेंट एंड थर्ड इज NRLM. तो रिमेंबर दीज 3 वर्ड्स इंस्टेड ऑफ रिमेंबरिंग द होल सेंटेंसेस. तो रिकॉल कुछ मेमोरी टेक्निक्स भी हैं, यू हैव टू फोकस ऑन दोज ओनली बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली इट इज ऑल अबाउट रिकॉलिंग. याद तो करना ही है ना, ठीक है? दिस इज एक वन आस्पेक्ट हाउ टू रिमेंबर थिंग्स. सेकेंड आस्पेक्ट इन हिस्ट्री, it is to make a story. If you remember the story, you will remember everything, right? So what I'll do is, we'll go through the entire MIH syllabus right now. Ek bar usko briefly dekhenge ki what the story is, manjra kya hai, right? If we got the story right, we will remember all the dates right, right? Chalo, let's start. I'll start from 1453. This date is there. Why this date? Yes, this is the capture of Constantinople by the Ottoman Empire, fall of the Byzantine Empire. Why this date is important? Britishers will come to India, na? Pehle to nahi the. Earlier there was Silk Route. So why they will come to India? Because this route is blocked. That is why age of discovery starts. Koi kahan ja raha hai, koi India bol ke ja raha hai, to kahin aur pahunch gaya, Columbus. Koi India bol ke ja raha hai, to India hi pahunchega, Vasco da Gama. in 1498, right? So now, age of discovery, Europeans will come. Europeans will come, not only British, Europeans. And first among the Europeans will be the Portuguese. They will come 1498. Columbus was Spanish. So you will see wherever there is some Spanish influence in Latin America or Portuguese influence, it is because of the invasions by the Europeans. Portuguese will be the first to come to India, but later on, from competition by the British, they will be forced to flee. And there will be one more reason, that they will discover Brazil. So Brazil will be very lucrative, it is rich in natural resources, plantation crops, so wahan par proper shuru kar denge slavery and all those things. Portuguese will come, then Dutch will come, then the British will come, then French will come, the French will be the last. So now, what kind of prelims question can be framed on this fact? They can give you an order, who came first? Anna? So story yaad kar lo, questions apne aap yaad ho jayenge. So the Europeans come, right? Now when the Europeans come, still in this date, the Britishers will first come in 1608. Ab jaise sir keh rahe hain ki yaad nahi hota, yaar ye date to yaad karni padegi. There is no a way around it. You have to remember this. Now the Britishers have come, but still there is one major power in India, the Mughals. Aurangzeb will die in 1707. So story mein na, dates ka ye role hai. The dates will define the future course of events. So till now, kisi ki majal nahi hai panga lene ka, kyunki Aurangzeb is there. In 1688, the Britishers will also fight a war in Bengal. And they will be shut down because Aurangzeb was at that time. Uske baad, jab uski death hogi, no able successor will be there from 1707 till 1857. Why this date 1857? This is the first mutiny, first war of independence, which is kehte hain, yeah, 1857, Sepoy mutiny. Between this period, 12 Mughal leaders will be there, emperors will be there. Lot of succession wars, factory-sidal wars. Aapas mein bhai ladenge, ek to emperors ke bachche bhi bahut hote hain. Kaun aayega, pata nahi, confusion is there. Right? So now the Britishers is there. Now what will happen? Right now they are a trading company. Trading company. So there will be two aspects. Ek to they will try to establish supremacy over other European powers. Unse ladai jhagda hoga. And then later on, when they'll establish supremacy, they will fight with the princely states. Marathas, the Sikhs, the Mughals, Hyderabad, Awadh, un sab se ladai jhagda hoga. Right? Then what will happen later on? 1757, Battle of Plassey. Here they will defeat the Nawab of Bengal. Then one more event will be there, 1764, Battle of Buxar. They will defeat the combined army of the French, the Nawab of Awadh and Bengal Nawab. But there is a difference between Plassey and Buxar. Plassey mein to treachery se harayenge, conspiracy se harayenge. But in Buxar, they will defeat through military might. Alright, so many say ki Plassey was a turning point, but actually it was Buxar which was the turning point. Here they are a political power, but now here they are political as well as a military power. Now they can take on the other princely states. Right? Achha, ab yahan par Bengal mein chha gaye hain. To Bengal mein chha gaye hain, to ab what will happen? Slowly and steadily they will spread to other areas also. So there will be some wars with the Marathas. They will fight in 1775. They will lose. First Anglo-Maratha war. Marathas are still strong. They are a power to be reckoned with. Later on, they will fight amongst themselves. Marathas aapas mein ladne lage. Mughal to khatam ho gaye, right? Hyderabad will also be weakened. Mysore, 1799. Tipu Sultan will die. Theek hai na? Then in 1818, third Anglo-Maratha war will be there. And here, the Marathas will be completely annihilated. They will be reduced to a small area in the west, western coast. राइट. तो डेट्स क्यों याद कर रहे हैं हम? बिकॉज दीज डेट्स आर सिग्निफिकेंट. दे मार्क अ चेंज इन द कैरेक्टर ऑफ द ब्रिटिश रूल. फ्रॉम 1818 नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस? द ब्रिटिशर्स आर द डोमिनेंट. अब 1818 से दे विल ट्राई टू बुली एवरीवन. मुगल्स खत्म हो गए, मराठास भी खत्म हो गए, कोई बचा नहीं. द सिख्स आर देयर, बट विद द सिख्स ऑल्सो इन 1809 दे हैव साइंड अ ट्रीटी के टू द नॉर्थ ऑफ सतलुज इट इज योर टेरिटरी एंड टू द साउथ ऑफ सतलुज इट इज आर टेरिटरी. तो देर इज अ डिप्लोमेटिक एंगल ऑल्सो. सो दे आर यूजिंग मिलिट्री एज वेल एज डिप्लोमेसी टू सेव गार्ड टू एक्सपैंड देयर एम्पायर. नाउ कम्स 1857. दिस इज नाउ अ मार्की इवेंट. अब ये क्यों है इवेंट? बिकॉज देर वर सम ग्रीवांसेज, कुछ कुछ ग्रीवांसेज हो रहे हैं. दे आर नाउ एनेक्सिंग अवध ऑल्सो एंड देन म्यूटनी हैपन्स. नाउ आफ्टरवर्ड्स अगेन देर विल बी अ चेंज इन देयर कैरेक्टर. वॉट चेंज? ब्रिटिश से नाउ वी विल नॉट एनेक्स, वी विल नॉट एनेक्स प्रिंसली स्टेट्स, वी विल नाउ को ऑप्ट देम. ठीक है, उनको अपने अंडर रखेंगे बट डायरेक्ट रूल नहीं करेंगे उनके ऊपर, बिकॉज दैट हैज लेड टू दिस म्यूटनी. So the causes for the mutiny they will try to remove. Now simultaneously in 1764 Buxar is there, so some administrative changes also will be there. So in 1765 they will introduce dual system whereby jo mazduri ka kaam hai wo nawab ka hai, jaise law and order maintain karna, aur jo paise kamane wala kaam hai land revenue, that is the work of Britishers. 1765 dual system. अब ये लोग बहुत पैसा कमा रहे हैं. दे आर नॉट द ब्रिटिशर्स, दे आर द ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी. तो किसी को पैसा मिल रहा है, कोई बहुत राइज कर रहा है, ऑब्वियसली देर विल बी जेलसी. हु वॉन्ट्स टू सी अदर पर्सन राइज एंड बिकम फेमस. एंड तो इन द ब्रिटिश पार्लियामेंट इन देयर एट देयर होम द अदर कंपनीज विल ट्राई टू ब्रिंग देम डाउन. दे विल से वी नीड सम रेगुलेशन ओवर देम. दे विल ऑल्सो से कि देर आर रिपोर्ट्स कि हरास कर रहे हैं नेटिव्स को. ट्राई टू बिकम द दे विल ट्राई टू प्रोजेक्ट देम सेल्फ द मसाया कि भाई हम उनके हित में बात करें, बट एक्चुअली दे वॉन्ट टू रिड्यूस द प्रॉफिट्स और एटलीस्ट गेट सम एंट्री इन टू द इंडियन मार्केट्स. राइट नाउ ओनली द ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी हैज द राइट्स टू ट्रेड इन इंडिया एज वेल एज इन चाइना ऑल्सो, विल सी. तो कुछ कुछ रेगुलेटिंग एक्ट आएगी पहले 1773, देन पिट्स इंडिया एक्ट विल कम 1784, देन 1813 एक्ट विल बी देयर अंडर विच मोनोपोली विद इंडिया ओवर ट्रेड एक्सेप्ट फॉर टी विल बी अबॉलिश्ड. फिर आगे एक और एक्ट आएगा 1833, देन 1853, देन दिस बम एक्ट इन 1858 आफ्टर द म्यूटिनी. अंडर दिस एक्ट द ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी विल बी अबॉलिश्ड एंड ऑल ऑफ द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव वर्क विल कम डायरेक्टली अंडर द क्राउन. ठीक है ना? तो अब 1858 पे क्वेश्चन आया पिछली बार, तो इट इज नॉट अ ट्रिवियल इवेंट, इट इज अ मेजर इवेंट. पिट्स इंडिया एक्ट एक इंपॉर्टेंट इवेंट है बिकॉज हेयर बोर्ड ऑफ कंट्रोल हैज बीन एस्टेब्लिश्ड. बोर्ड ऑफ कंट्रोल अंडर विच कैबिनेट मिनिस्टर्स विल बी देयर. तो सम सॉर्ट ऑफ रेगुलेशन बाय द पार्लियामेंट इज देयर. देन दिस एक्ट कम्स. अब तो क्राउन ही डायरेक्ट हो गया. तो जहां जहां कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट होगा ना, द यूपीएससी विल आस्क ओनली दोज एस्पेक्ट्स, स्पेशली इन प्रीलिम्स. 1858 के बाद सम काउंसिल एक्ट्स विल बी देयर, बट द नेक्स्ट मेजर एक्ट विल बी 1909, सेपरेट इलेक्टोरेट्स. Separate electorates in which Muslims can only vote for Muslims. They can only elect Muslims. अब 1909 Act क्यों आया? 1858 तो आपको पता है क्यों आया? Mutiny थी, cause remove करने. 1909 क्यों आया? Those who have given prelims, tell me. Partition of Bengal, right? तो partition of Bengal, the movement had died. After 1907 split, movement had died. Why this act? There were some revolutionary activities also going on, right? Yes, one was to appease the Muslims because they had promised them that they will shift, they will make Dhaka as the Muslim capital, right? But in 1911 they annulled. So to appease the Muslims as well as to curb down revolutionary activities as well as to increase the prestige of the moderates, because the split has happened. Right, this strategy of Britishers will always be there. Not only they will play divide and rule among extremists and moderates and revolutionaries, but also among Hindus and Muslims, even the Sikhs also later on. So isliye 19, then 1919 Act, The unique thing about it is diarchy. Two subjects will be there under provinces reserved for Governor General and transferred for elected councils. But again, why 1919 Act? That will be after 1919. 1919, you know, Home Rule League movement will be there, 1916, right? So, har cheez ka cause hai. Everything has a cause. Then later on, 1935 Act, why this was given? Quit India movement, 1930, but it had died in 1931 only. And in 1934, Gandhiji had given a formal announcement that now we withdraw this movement. So, ye act kyun aaya fir? But movement had died, na? Pressure to hai nahi. Dekho, Britishers are not benevolent. They will not give something because they feel, yaar, sahi baat hai, bichare bade tarse hain. Roundtable conference had happened, right? But Congress participated only one of the roundtable conference. What is the reason? Divide and rule policy again. Except for the Congress, the princely states had participated, Ambedkar had participated, Muslims had participated, the industrialists had participated. So the Britishers want to show, dekho, tum log mass movement kar rahe ho, kuch nahi mila tumhe. The moderates had participated and the other independents had participated. Because of them only we are giving you Government of India. So put your support behind the constitutional measures and not behind mass movements. Right? And there was also one more reason, there was change of government also. The labors were supposed to come to the power in next elections and the conservatives thought that we need to make this constitutional arrangement now only. Pata nahi labor baad mein aake kya kar de, kahin independence hi na de rahe hain. Right? So everything has a reason. So this is the whole strand of constitutional development. Aapka pura story ban gayi na. Now a whole story is there. You will be able to remember ki what is the thing. And there are some unique aspects. Isme separate electorate hai. Isme diarchy at the provinces, not at the center. Here, unique aspect is proposed federation. Diarchy was at the center, it was abolished at the provinces, but the unique aspect is federation. It didn't come into effect, but that is a unique aspect of this act. All right. Ab hum pahunche 1857. 1857 ke baad kya hoga? This mutiny is there, right? Some changes will be there. Now, after 1857, there will be increase of political consciousness. Because this, what is the unique thing about 1857 mutiny? It was a? Before that, there were movements. No movements. Scattered like? The tribals. Tribals, the peasants, unhone bhi kuch kuch movements kiye hain, but they were localized, not well connected. Here it is the, ye bhi chalo all India nahi tha, south ke, there was very little participation from the south, but still, pan India character was more. To iske according political consciousness hogi, then what is the logical step? Some political parties will be formed, kuch kuch pre-Congress parties form hogi, then in 1885, Congress will be formed. INC will be there, right? Ab INC bani hai, to initially, what is their motto? Poorn Swaraj, independence. No. They will not demand Poorn Swaraj, independence. They are not in a position. The formation is also through a English civil servant. So their method is prayer, plea and petition. PPP model they will take. Prayer, plea and petition. Self-government, thoda sa hume self-government de do. Give some representations in the councils. So slowly and steadily this movement, this demand, these demands will change. Initially, kya bolenge? Self-government, more representation. Then next phase will be there of the extremists. 1905, partition, Bengal. Now a new phase of leaders will come. Extremists. They are extremists because they support violence, right? Is it so? They don't support violence. Yes. Political? Very good. It is not just PPP. So it is not constitutional, it is extra constitutional. That is the differentiating factor. Violence is the creed of revolutionaries. The revolutionary freedom fighters, they will say ki we need violent methods to achieve our goals. So extremists will be there. They will launch the Swadeshi movement. Swadeshi mein, they will have three aims, right? One of the aim will be Swaraj. Now you will say Swaraj kya hai? They will not define it. Right? So we cannot say ki independence was first asked in Swadeshi movement, right? Then after 1905, there will be split, right? Split in Surat. Then later on, in 1911, partition will be annulled. Here, one more strand of political activity will grow from 1897 till 1915. It is the first phase of revolutionary movements. From Chapekar brothers till the Gadar movement. Gadar started in 1914 and they tried to have some violent revolution in India also. In San Francisco they started, but they failed. So this will be the first phase of revolutionary. There will be three phases of revolutionary movement. This is the first phase. It started with the partition of Bengal. Yahan se shuru hua. Right? Partition is annulled. Then what will happen? Tilak will also be sentenced. Tilak chala jayega. He was the leader of the extremists. Then what will happen? Home rule. Before that, Tilak will come back. Then 1916, Home Rule League. And also Lucknow Pact. Lucknow Pact means now they will realize ke boss divide nahi hona hai. Now there will never be a division in the Congress. Later on similar conditions will be there in NCM also, CDM mein bhi kuch kuch halat aise banenge. But Gandhi ji will realize this folly ke ab ke baad split nahi karna hai. We must be united. We must be together. Lucknow Pact will also signify one more move. That INC will accept separate electorates. They will accept separate electorates. This is one of the major follies of INC. Agar question aata hai baad mein ki, matlab mains point of view se aata hai, prelims mein to they will not ask, ke was Congress also responsible for the partition? So we will not say ki solely Muslim League is responsible. Congress is also responsible. And this is the genesis of the Pakistan movement, two nation theory, acceptance by the Congress of separate electorates, right? Then kya hoga? This movement will peter out 1917, it will die. Yahan par 1915 mein ek Maharathi aayenge yahan par. Gandhi ji will come here in India. Before that, wo South Africa mein machayenge khub. And he will be very successful also there. And then wahan par macha ke he will come to India ki ab yahan karte hain kuch. Though he was very reluctant because his demands were not fully met there in South Africa, but his colleagues there like C.F. Andrews. So we must also keep in mind the foreigners who were involved in the freedom struggle. Jahan jahan kisi foreigner ka naam dekhte ho, to keep that in mind. Jaise A.O. Hume ho gaya, A.N.E. Besant ho gaya, C.F. Andrews ho gaya. Keep that in mind. So they will say ki Gandhi now go back to India and do something for the country. So Gandhi ji will come here, but he will not take part in the Home Rule League movement. All right, because World War I is going on, na? So Gandhi ji is loyal to the British Empire, at least to the principles on which they stand, like democracy, justice, equality, liberty. Though they are not practicing that in India. So Gandhi ji will say, we should not exploit them at their moment of weakness. That is the stand of Gandhi. So Home Rule League mein nahi karenge participate. But some movements he will launch, like in 1917, Champaran mein kuch karenge. Then 1918, Ahmedabad mein, Kheda mein. These are small, small agitations he will launch. So his strategy is also very good. Agar ekdam se bolenge ki we need self-rule, fail ho jayega, Gandhi ji ki phir beizti ho jayegi, ki bhai ye bada aaya tha hero banne, kuch nahi kar paaya. So Gandhi ji first looks for small, small issues, so that he can have small, small victories. After that, he will launch 1919, Rowlatt Satyagraha. Against Rowlatt Act. Then later on, jab Jallianwala Bagh massacre ho jayega, and Khilafat question will be there. After the end of the World War I, many empires will die. World event ko bhi link karte chalo. Jaise, Ottoman Empire will collapse. Austro-Hungarian Empire will collapse, right? Then Germanic Empire, Teutonic Empire, they will collapse. So all these empires will collapse and the Britishers will mistreat the Khalifa there. They will take away the powers of the Khalifa over the control of religious places. So that will burn grievance of the Muslims in India. So they will say Khilafat. Khilafat will be launched before NCM. Later on they will be merged, right? So 1920 mein NCM launch hoga. It will have some distinct patterns. The participation of the Muslims in the freedom struggle will be the highest in NCM. Iske baad kabhi aisi participation nahi hogi Muslims ki. They will be reduced to the fringes, right? Ek to dekho Muslim League form hogi hai 1906 mein. Later on they will become dominant. In abhi to dominant nahi hai. Initially INC is only dominant. Later on they will become dominant. And the Muslims will completely side then with Muslim League. So the participation of Muslims is highest in NCM. So kuch unique aspects jo hote hai na, that you must keep in mind. Like industrialist, they will not participate in the freedom struggle until CDM. CDM mein karenge participate. Why? Because unko bhi to dhanda karna hai na. Businessman ke liye sabse important cheez kya hai? Tell me Vignesh. Profits to hai, but stability with the political class. Agar Congress power mein hai to Congress ke saath bana ke rakho. Agar BJP power mein hai to BJP ke saath bana ke rakho. So now the people in power are the Britishers. So they need to have some linkages with the British. Though British policies are anti-industrialist. Indian industrialist, sorry. Right? But still, kuch. But CDM mein jab unko lagega ki yes, now we must push our weight behind the freedom struggle. To wahan par CDM mein, again, not as a whole group, but some industrialists will support and some will not, like that. Later on, support will grow. Achha, iske baad kya event hoga? Chori chora hoga, right? Movement will be withdrawn, 1922. Movement will be withdrawn, then what will happen? Jo log mobilize hue hain, wo kahenge, ab kya karein? Zombies ki tarah ghoom rahe hain, wo kya karein? Unko, they have no work. Many of the students in schools and colleges, they have been asked to drop out and participate in the freedom struggle. Now what to do? There is no going back. So, yes. Second phase of revolutionary movements will be there and some breakaway parties will also be formed. Like 90, yahan par liberal party banegi. Liberals under Tej Bahadur Sapru, wo kahenge yaar extra constitutional measures will not support. Will only support constitutional measures. Right? Jo Swadeshi mein hua hai, wohi sab NCM mein bhi ho raha hai. But the difference is that it is happening on a bigger scale under Gandhiji. Gandhiji has brought in peasants and workers also in the fold. Pehle they were not that much touched. That is the unique thing about Gandhiji. Aap kahoge Gandhiji jo kar rahe the tilak wahi to kar raha tha pehle. Right? But Gandhiji kept everyone in the fold because interests of workers and interests of industrialists are opposite. Mante ho? To kaise rakhe unko saath? Industrialists ke liye kuch kahenge to workers will say this is wrong. Interests of peasants and interests of zamindars, they are antagonistic. How to keep them together? Interest of Hindus and Muslims because of communalization. Again, how to keep them together? Right? So that is the skill of Gandhiji. He was not only a religious leader, he was a good political leader also. When to do what he knew. Alright. So after this, one more party will be there. Congress Khilafat Swarajist Party. Because after, they had also asked to ban entry into councils. Right? So after the secession of the movement, question arises whether to enter again or not. So kuch bolenge karte enter, kuch bolenge nahi, they will have some reasons. Jo bol rahe enter kar rahe hain, they'll say ki we are not entering because of our greed. We are entering otherwise other anti-social elements will enter, communal elements will enter, who will work against our interests. So that is why we need to enter the councils. Those who say we should not enter the councils, wo kahenge ki constructive work will be hindered. It will be sidelined, right? So, kuch reasons honge, ek nahi party ban ke aayegi. Ab jo youth mobilize, bhai youth ko to kuch samajh nahi aa raha. They are full of energy, right? There are three phases in our life. We have three things always. First is money, then time, and then energy. So, initially when we are young, we have a lot of time and we have a lot of energy, but we don't have money. Then later on, jab job lag jati hai and family life shuru ho jati hai, then we have a lot of energy and we have a lot of money, but no time. फिर जब थर्ड लास्ट फेज आता है जब बूढ़े हो जाते हैं, वी हैव अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम, वी हैव अ लॉट ऑफ मनी ऑल्सो, बट वी हैव नो एनर्जी, राइट? तो अभी यूथ के पास क्या है? दे हैव अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम एंड दे हैव अ लॉट ऑफ एनर्जी, तो दे मस्ट चैनलाइज इट समवेयर. गांधी जी ने तो विड्रॉ कर लिया, तो नाउ रेवोल्यूशनरी एक्टिविटीज. 1924 HRA, सेकेंड फेज ऑफ रेवोल्यूशनरी एक्टिविटीज विल गो, राइट? एंड दिस विल गो टिल 1931 चित्तागोंग रेड. 1929 में भगत सिंह विल ड्रॉप द बॉम्ब. 1931 चित्तागोंग रेड इन बंगाल साइड. आफ्टर दैट सूर्यसेन, अंडर सूर्यसेन दिस विल एंड. दिस विल बी द सेकेंड फेज ऑफ रेवोल्यूशनरी एक्टिविटीज, राइट? नाउ काउंसिल एंट्री हैज बीन देयर एंड सम कंस्ट्रक्टिव वर्क इज ऑल्सो देयर. बाय 1926 गांधी जी विल से कि अब बहुत रेस्ट कर लिया, नाउ अगेन वी नीड टू हैव सम मास मूवमेंट. एंड ऑल्सो साइमन कमीशन हैज बीन अपॉइंटेड बाय द ब्रिटिशर्स टू लुक इन टू कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल डेवलपमेंट्स. तो 1927 साइमन कमीशन कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड. ही विल कम इन टू इंडिया इन 1928. ही विल गिव दैट कमीशन विल गिव इट्स रिकमेंडेशन इन 1930 एंड मैनी ऑफ देम विल बी रिफ्लेक्टेड इन द 1935 एक्ट. तो उसके अगेंस्ट साइमन गो बैक के नारे लगेंगे, लाला जी की मृत्यु हो जाएगी. इन 1928 ओनली HRA हैज चेंज टू HSRA, हिंदुस्तान सोशलिस्ट रिपब्लिकन आर्मी और एसोसिएशन. एंड दे हैड सेड कि नाउ वी नीड टू मूव अवे फ्रॉम द पाथ ऑफ वायलेंस बिकॉज उसके थ्रू हमें मास सपोर्ट नहीं मिल पा रही है. दे रियलाइज देयर फॉली. भगत सिंह करेक्टेड द स्ट्रैटेजी, बट लाला जी की डेथ होगी. अब बदला तो लेना है, बदला तो बनता है बॉस. लाला जी की मृत्यु का बदला बनता है. सो नाउ दे विल असैसिनेट द पर्सन रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द डेथ एंड दे विल ऑल्सो नाउ थ्रो द बॉम्ब्स इन असेंबली. 1929 एंड आफ्टर 1929 ओनली द पॉपुलैरिटी ऑफ भगत सिंह विल ग्रो, नॉट बिफोर दैट. पहले तो कोई नहीं जानता था बिकॉज इट इज द डिजाइन ऑफ द रेवोल्यूशनरी एक्टिविटीज कि यू विल रिमेन एनोनिमस ओनली. और अखबार वाली भी छापेंगे तो क्या छापेंगे? गैर जिम्मेदार हरकत, राइट? ऑल द रेवोल्यूशनरी एक्टिविटीज विल गैर जिम्मेदार. सो आफ्टर दे गो ऑन द हंगर स्ट्राइक इन द जेल दे विल गेन पॉपुलैरिटी एंड थिंग्स विल गो ऑन लाइक दैट. देन आफ्टर भगत सिंह विल बी असैसिनेटेड 1930 ही विल बी हैंग एंड द सुखदेव एंड राजगुरु. 1930 गांधी जी विल गिव 311 डिमांड्स टू इरविन. तो अब आप सोचोगे कि डिमांड्स देने की क्या जरूरत है, पता ही था नहीं मानेंगे. बट ही हैज टू सेट सम कंटेक्स्ट ऑल्सो ना. ऐसी लॉन्च कर देंगे मास मूवमेंट देन पीपल विल नॉट रैली बिहाइंड. फर्स्ट ही हैज टू क्रिएट मोमेंटम ऑल्सो. सो विल सेंड 11 डिमांड्स. केरविन एक्सेप्ट दीज 11 डिमांड्स, अदरवाइज आता माजी सटकेल. आई विल लॉन्च CDM. देन CDM विल बी लॉन्च्ड. Irwin will say, okay, come to the round table conference. First round table conference will be boycotted. Second, many of the leaders will be put in jail. So Gandhi ji say, now it is time for some truce. So he will attend the round table conference. Though he knew that nothing good will come out, kuch aayega nahi, but still he attended. And that is what happened. Nothing good came out. Then he again came back to India and he said, now again let's launch CDM. But the British are smart. Jaisi Gandhi ji hai, Gandhi ji ko jail mein dal diya. Most of the leaders were put in jail and the CDM, it petered out, right? Second roundtable Congress attended. So prelims mein kya aspect aayega? Which of the roundtable conferences Congress attended? Third roundtable conference also happened. It was again attended by those who were in favor of the British rule. Some of their demands will be accepted. A federation will be proposed. Then communal award will be given in 1932. Pune Pact usme sign hoga. 1932 Pune Pact will be signed and Ambedkar, he will agree, yes, separate electorates nahi hona chahiye but separate representation hona chahiye, right? Separate representation for the Dalits, right? Pune Pact, 1932. So this is now end of CDM. Now again a question arises, ab kya karein? Again the question for council entry, karein ke na karein? Right? So again there will be two groups. Now Nehru ji is also in the fray. In 1927 the resolution for boycott of Simon Commission, in that resolution Nehru ji was successful in passing a resolution for complete independence. So if prelims mein fact poochte hain complete independence kab pass kiya, so it is 1927 session. Later on in 1928 Nehru report jab nikal ke aayegi, it will ask for dominion status again, and in 1929 again they will declare for complete independence. All right. So ye kuch aspects hain on which UPSC will play. When complete independence was declared as the goal, which commission later on will see ki bahut sare commissions aayenge. They will recommend some constitutional structure. So they will ask which recommended dominion, which recommended freedom, right? So aise kare, these unique aspects should be kept in mind for prelims. And for mains, story puri yaad karu. All right. 1932, then in 1934, Socialist Party will be formed. Now Nehru ji is in the fray. So the growth of socialism is taking place in India. Bose bhi honge leadership mein. Right, Bose will also favor socialism. So now socialism will also grow in India. And in between, council entry will be there. So council entry hogi, 1937 mein elections honge, and INC will emerge victorious in most of the provinces. Puri unki mawahawai ho jayegi. So Gandhi ji was initially not in favor of council entry, but later on in agreed. Because he said ki it will boost the morale of the people. Bhai ab movement to peter out hogi hai. We need something. So the Congress will win the seats, then will say, yes, something good is going on. You need a positive feeling, na? Kuch nahi bhi ho raha hai, tab bhi bolo. Achha ho raha hai sab kuch. All right, it is ultimately psychological. Then after 1937, what will happen? 1939, one major event. World War. Mein, Congress ministries will resign. There was a question in 2012 also. Ki why the Congress ministries resigned in 1939? They were given some options. Why did they resign? Yes. They unilaterally they declared that India is on the side of the Allies. So ye unilaterally declared, bhai, we are at the provinces, we are elected. Ask us na, why are you unilaterally declaring? That is why they, alright, so not, it is not ki outbreak of war or to protest against the war. It is because of this precise reason. So story clear up, 1939 mein ye ho gaya. Now in, after 1935 again question, 1939 question arises ki what to do next? Should I rub this? Mitaal? Okay, I'll write here. question arises, hun ki kariya jaye, what to do next? Should we launch a mass movement? People are divided. Gandhi ji, what is his position? We should not take advantage of the British at a time of their weakness. Gandhi ji is not favor. Socialist, they are in favor. Communist, they are in favor. Communist ka bahut, they will take U-turns frequently. In 1939, they will say ke we should take advantage of this World War situation and agitate for freedom. But in 1941, there is one major world event concerning USSR. Germany will invade USSR, 1941. So now what is the position of the communist? Wo kahenge, bhai, comrades, they are under attack, and the Britishers are an ally of the comrades. So now this is a people's war. Now we should support the British. So that is why communist ko jada support nahi mil paya. Whatever support they got in the Bengal only. Jada nahi mila. Because their position was always changing. It was not stagnant. Then there is a third strand of leaders like Nehru. They say ki dekho, Britishers are not fighting for democracy or justice. It is totally farce. Lad to sab imperialist concerns ke liye rahe hain. But there is a difference between the British and the German and the Italians and the Japanese. The Allies are democratic. They represent democracy, whereas they represent fascism. Fascism, dictatorship, extreme nationalism, expansionist policy. But still we will maintain status quo. That is the position of Nehru. So koi kuch nahi karega, 1939 mein ye decide hua. But there is one leader, Subhash Chandra Bose. He was a civil servant also. He will not stop at anything. So he will resign from the Congress and he will go to Calcutta and say, "Main kal hi bahut hai inke liye. I will launch a CDM." So he will go to Calcutta. He will try to garner support. Obviously, he will not get the support. He will be put behind bars also. Alright, unka ye chalega. Fir next he will go to Berlin. Wahan se he will launch a radio, Azad Hind Radio. Then he will come to Singapore. Wahan par Indian National Army ko reorganize karega. 1940 Indian National Army has been formed by Mohan Singh. Later on in 43, Subhash Chandra Bose reorganized it. Because in 43, the tables have turned. Japanese were winning. Now they are on the back foot. So initially, INA ko treat kar rahe the ki bhai ye to chote log hain. But after that, they will treat, yes, please support us. We need your help. So they will ask, they will give Subhash Chandra Bose equal status. Ye to story hai Subhash Chandra Bose ki. Then later on, Gandhi ji kya karenge abhi? Individual Satyagraha. Because he will take the middle path of the Buddha. He will not launch a mass movement, but he will also not stay quiet. He will launch individual Satyagrahas. Individual Satyagrahas. To protest against the unilateral decision. Ab beech mein Britishers ko bhi support chahiye na. Though they have put the Indian army, the Indian soldiers in the war, but still ek leadership se to unko chahiye na thappa ki yes, we are with you. So they will also give some kind of concessions. So there are four important constitutional developments after the outbreak of World War I, World War II. First is the August offer. Then it is the Cripps Mission. Then it is the Wavell Plan. And lastly is the Cabinet. Right? ये चार चीजें हैं बड़ी कंफ्यूजन हो जाती है कौन कब आया क्या हो रहा है कुछ समझ नहीं आ रहा राइट बट इन सब के पीछे देर इज सम लॉजिक राइट ऑगस्ट ऑफर 1940 आउटब्रेक ऑफ वॉर वेवल प्लान 1945 दिस इज 1942 एंड दिस इज माई लास्ट 1946 विच ऑफ देम विल ग्रांट Which of them will recommend independence for India? Four options are August offer, Cripps Mission, Wavell Plan and Cabinet Mission. Cabinet Mission. The only time that the Britishers accepted a demand for independence. It is the Cabinet Mission. Unique cheez hai, yaad honi chahiye. There are reasons for it, but Unique aspect is ki iski recommendation mein kya important hai, what we need to import. Which of them accepted Pakistan? They accepted yes, Pakistan should be created. None of them. Mountbatten. None of them accepted. So ye bhi ek cheez, ye prelims se pooch lete hain wo. So this is what you need. Clarity honi chahiye ki kis mein kya hua hai, right? So none of them accepted Pakistan. टू नेशन थ्योरी 1940 में रेजोल्यूशन पास होगा लाहौर रेजोल्यूशन टू नेशन थ्योरी का बाय मुस्लिम लीग बट नन ऑफ देम विल एक्सेप्ट ऑलराइट 1940 ये क्यों आएगा यू आर क्लियर भाई वर्ल्ड वॉर वन हो गया है दे नीड इंडियन सपोर्ट देन इंडिविजुअल सत्याग्रह विल कम बिटवीन दिस पीरियड अब 1942 में क्रिप्स मिशन वाई अगेन दे आर सेंडिंग सम काइंड ऑफ प्रपोजल्स टू अस कि कुछ कुछ दे देंगे भाई तुम्हें आ जाओ सपोर्ट कर लो वाई December 1941, very important world event. Movie bani us pe Pearl Harbor. Attack by the Japanese on the Pearl Harbor, December 1941. And after that, Japanese are expanding eastwards. They have captured Singapore, Malaya. Wahan se sab Britishers ko bhaga diya. So they are at the frontiers. They are knocking at the door. So that is why they need support of. Tabhi dubara Cripps Mission bheja hai. Tabhi Cripps Mission bheja hai. In between 1942 to 1945, Quit India Movement will be launched. Why? Abhi to war chal raha hai, khatam thodi hua hai. Gandhi ji to keh rahe the ki we will not take advantage of their weakness, the moment of weakness. Vignesh? Yes. So Japanese are now advancing, and Gandhi ji has seen that the Britishers have left the people in Malaya and Singapore at the mercy of the Japanese. Sab chhod chhad ke bhag gaye ekdam, kisi ka khyal nahi rakha. So if similar condition happens in India, Japanese invade India, they will leave us. And Gandhiji knows that the Japanese cannot be the liberators of Indians. They are fascist. Fascist nahi hai. They are dictators. So then Gandhiji launches Quit India movement. Ki now we need to take control of our destiny. So if question comes ki why Quit India movement has been launched. So it is option de diya, outbreak of World War I, World War II, failure of Cripps mission, all those things can be there. So important reason can be there. UPSC is asking two kind of questions in prelims. One is fact-based, jaise sir keh rahe the ki trivial aa raha kuch, 1919 act mein what is important. And then some questions are, some kind of analytical aspect is there. Ke after the arrival of the British, justice became, what was the condition of justice in India, ya judicial institutions ka, what were the aspects. So they can give you two, three statements. Justice became costly, it became inaccessible, some kind of things can be there, right? So these, keep these two aspects in mind, analytical as well as factual. Then Wewell will be there, again there will be a change of government, yahan par kuch ho raha hoga. So they will send a Wewell plan. They will, all of them will offer dominion status, they will be rejected, and all of them will say a union. So Muslim League will also reject. Muslim League will reject because they want Pakistan. They believe in two nation theory. Though after independence, Jinnah said that this is now a secular country and everyone of any faith, they are free to practice their religion. But his demands at the inception of Pakistan were different. Then lastly, cabinet mission. Cabinet mission ke kuch recommendations hogi. It also rejected demand for Pakistan, right? And it offered independence. So this is your whole story of modern Indian history. Anji? Wewell plan mein basically they are giving some kind of groupings, right? Jo baad mein cabinet mission mein pura concrete ho jayega aapka. We'll see everything in detail. Abhi bas story yaad karo ki what is going on, why it is going on, right? There is one more important aspect. After 1818, socio-religious reform movements. These movements, basically important date here is 1813. Why this date is important? Because Charter Act of 1813 says that now Christian missionaries will be allowed to spread Christianity and modern education. So if a new religion, a new reform system comes, what will happen? Comparisons will be there. So comparisons will be there, so aapas mein friction hogi, reforms will be there. Alright, so that is the reason. Reforms honge sabse first will be Atmiya Sabha, which will later on form into Brahmo Samaj in 1828. Then various other reform, Prathna Samaj niklega, Arya Samaj niklega 1875, Ramkrishna Mission 1897. So different social religious reform movements will also be there. This will be one aspect which we'll cover. So again, there will be some kind of story. All right. So this is your whole syllabus for modern Indian history. Got it? Story samaj aagi na? Story ek bar samaj aa jaye, then dates are very easy to remember. We don't have to remember dates on a standalone basis. We have to remember dates integrated in a story. And every date will signify some major event. And because of that event, some changes will be there. So if story yaad hai to, everything will be simple. Alright. Now what we'll do is, we'll start with the advent of Britishers. स्टोरी की शुरुआत कहां से हमारे सिलेबस में एडवेंट ऑफ द यूरोपियंस राइट एंड देयर स्ट्रगल विद द प्रिंसली स्टेट्स प्रिंसली स्टेट्स उनके साथ कुछ कुछ लड़ाई झगड़ा चल रहा है, यूरोपियन पास, एंड अमंग्स देम वी हैव द ब्रिटिशर्स हु आर आवर मेन एरिया ऑफ कंसर्न एंड विच इज ऑल्सो द मेन एरिया ऑफ कंसर्न फॉर यूपीएससी. तो वॉट विल डू इज विल टेक दीज टू आस्पेक्ट्स एट द लास्ट, बाद में देखेंगे इसे. स्टोरी इनकी तो क्लियर है ना, वैसे स्टोरी इज क्लियर के वॉट कम्स अंडर दीज टू टॉपिक्स. अंडर दीज टू टॉपिक्स द एंग्लो फ्रेंच राइवलरी विल बी देयर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 1754 एंड राइवलरी विद अदर यूरोपियन पावर्स ऑल्सो. दैट इज अ मोस्ट लीस्ट सिग्निफिकेंट टॉपिक, तो उसको बाद में देखेंगे. एंड ऑल्सो when the Britishers will occupy Bengal in 1757, there will be rivalry with other princely states till 1857 when they will emerge as the dominant power. वैसे तो 1818 में they will emerge as the dominant, but after 1857 crown will take over control. तो we'll keep these two topics at the end, इनको बाद में देखेंगे. पहले जो fleshy part है उसको देख लेते हैं पहले, right? The Britishers. Now the Britishers arrived first at in 1608 the Britishers will arrive at Surat. Captain Hawkins in the court of Jahangir. Right. In 1600, a company called Merchant Adventurers, they had been granted the charter by Queen Elizabeth for 15 years. So the first two voyages which they took to the Spice Islands as well as to India, as well as to Africa, they made 500-600% profits. Itna bumper profit hua unhe. To bumper profit hone ke baad, they said ki yaar, we need to establish permanent contact. कुछ जाके उनसे बात बात करते हैं. तो 1608 कैप्टन हॉकिंग्स विल गो टू द कोर्ट ऑफ जहांगीर एंड ही विल आस्क फॉर ट्रेडिंग राइट्स. ऑलराइट, फरमान उन्हें मिलेगा. एंड यू सी मोस्ट ऑफ द यूरोपियन पावर्स दे फर्स्ट एस्टैब्लिश देयर ट्रेडिंग पोस्ट इन साउथ. एक ज्योग्राफिकल यूनिकनेस दिख रही है ना, व्हाई? अच्छा, वेरी गुड रीजन. वन इज पोर्ट्स. Okay, they had a strong navy and they needed the ports. So, theek hai, trade ke liye.
There was no Mughal rule.
Yes.
Area rich in spices.
One very important reason is that Mughal hold in south was indirect. Aap dekhoge, Awadh, Bengal Nawab, Nizam, all of them are under the Mughal rule only. Though they are independent kingdoms, right? बट दे रिकोगनाइज दी अथॉरिटी ऑफ दी मुगल्स. 1707 में जब औरंगजेब की डेथ होगी, देन दे विल एस्टैब्लिश स्ट्रॉन्ग होल्ड ओवर देयर पर्सनल फीफडम्स. लाइक बंगाल में चला जाएगा अलीवर्दी खान, ये मुर्शीद कुली खान, ही वॉज देयर नवाब एट इन 1700 ओनली. इन 1717 ही विल बी कन्फर्ड एज द नवाब देयर फॉर्मली. देन इन द साउथ निज़ाम विल गेयर 1722. Right, so like this they will establish strongholds, but now also indirectly the hold of the Mughals is there, so they can spread their business, they can flourish their business more in the south. So that is why they established in the south first. Then this is at the west coast. In the east coast, in 1611 they established a trading factory at Maslipatnam. Right, then later on they will establish three major bases. One at Madras in 1639. They will establish Fort George there. Factories, वहाँ पर factory में कोई production नहीं होती थी. It was basically a name given where they have housing there, right? और वहाँ पर trading कर सकते हैं. That is their अड्डा. Then in 1668, they established their second base in Bombay. Bombay was initially under the rule of the Portuguese, but there was some war going on between Portugal and Spain. So the English, they helped the Portuguese there, and in return, the British government, they got Bombay Islands. And later on in 1668, the East India Company purchased those islands from the British government. So 1668, they established their second base. In 1651, they had established a factory at Hooghly in Bengal. Or 1688, mein, they established a fort there, Fort William. And they established their third permanent base at Kolkata. So these were the three major bases of the British. 1639, 1668 and 1688. So these are the important facts you have to remember. So when they arrived, this is important. Then their three bases, these are important. Madras, Bombay and Kolkata. It was Calcutta actually. Kalikatta tha ek gaon. Teen gaon the, usme se ek tha Kalikatta, usko khareed liya aur unko fir baad mein they developed into Calcutta. Now question can come here ki the chronological order of the establishment of three bases in prelims, right? In mains, they may ask you to trace the advent of the Britishers in India. So you can trace it like this. Then later on, the next important event, it is the 1717 Farman. Given by the emperor, that Mughal emperor at that time, Farooq Siyar. He gave this Farman to the East India Company, under which they can trade duty free in Bengal and Hyderabad. Duty free. So digest the important words. The company only got this right, not the servants of the company. Jo unke officials the, they had to pay taxes. Dastak ek important technical term hai. Dastak is the tax paid on the passage of goods. So dastak free ho gaya company ko, but not for the servants. This was the Farman, 1717 Farman under Farooq Siyar. Ab Bengal mein kya hai? Murshid Kuli Khan, he becomes the Nawab at that time, and later on he is succeeded by Aliwardi Khan. Aliwardi Khan will die in 1756 and he will be succeeded by Siraj ud-Daulah. So these two Nawabs, they were very strong, Murshid Kuli Khan and Aliwardi Khan. They had a strong hold over the administration. So they prevented the company from misusing the Farman. 1717 ka jo Farman tha, uska misuse they prevented. But after their death, some kind of misuse to chali raha tha kuch kuch, but rampant ho gaya phir wo misuse. Even the servants, they were not paying dastaks on their personal trade. Theek hai na? Cornwallis jab aayega 1786 mein, he will become the Governor General. He will reform the civil services. Before him, the civil servants were paid very poorly. So, bhai, ab jahan tankha bahut kam hai, to wahan par kya hoga? Corruption will be there. So, they engaged in corruption, in private trade, khud wahan par karne trade. That is their major source of income. So, now this Siraj ud-Daulah, when he will come, this misuse will become rampant. And he is a very hot-headed guy. He is not diplomatic or experienced as the earlier two Nawabs, and he will take a very strong action against this misuse. But the company, instead of obeying him, they will start levying taxes on the Indian merchants bhi, ki tum bhi tax do hume, we are the boss, right? 1688 mein bhi ek war hua tha. This is not the first time ki some kind of confrontation has happened between the East India Company and the Indian rulers. In 1688 also this kind of problem was there in Bengal, but at that time kaun jinda tha? Papa inke jinda the, Aurangzeb. So he shut them down. But then again they said ki bhai gareeb hain, bacche hain, maaf kar do, galti ho jati hai, badon ko to maaf kar dena chahiye. So diplomacy they played, एंड उसने औरंगजेब भी कहा चल ठीक है ओके कंटिन्यू विद योर ट्रेड बिकॉज ही थॉट दे आर मेयर ट्रेडिंग कंपनी बट देयर डिजाइंस फॉर समथिंग एल्स इन 1650 स्लेव ट्रेड इज गोइंग ऑन राइट तो स्लेव ट्रेड ने बहुत बूस्ट कर दिया इनका मोराल एंड फाइनेंसिस ऑल्सो तो दीज इंपीरियलिस्ट डिजाइंस ही इज नॉट एबल टू सी इन अफ्रीका वॉट इज गोइंग ऑन हाउ दे आर कॉलोनाइजिंग अफ्रीका हाउ दे आर कॉलोनाइजिंग लैटिन अमेरिका औरंगजेब इज नॉट एबल टू सी दीज डिजाइंस एंड ऑल्सो देर आर सम अदर डिफेक्ट्स ऑल्सो जब हम प्रिंसली स्टेट्स वाला टॉपिक करेंगे विल डू द डिक्लाइन ऑफ द मुगल एम्पायर एंड सी वॉट वर द रीजन्स तो 1688 दिस हैपेंड बट देवर डिफीटेड अगेन नो प्रॉब्लम अराइजेस सिराज उद दौला देन टेक्स अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग स्टेप ही डिक्लेयर्स वॉर उनका फोर्ट विलियम पे सीज लेकर देंगे एंड द ब्रिटिशर्स विल फ्ली देर इज अ ब्लैक होल इंसिडेंट ऑल्सो के द कैप्चर्ड ब्रिटिश प्रिजनर्स दे विल बी कैप्ट इन द जेल और बहुत सारे प्रिजनर्स को एक छोटी सी जेल में दे विल कैंप देम एंड मैनी ऑफ देम विल डाई ड्यू टू सफोकेशन तो जैसे हमारे यहाँ कुछ फोकलोर्स है ना कि 1857 म्यूटनी को ऐसे दबाया मास किलिंग्स वर मैसेकर्स वर देयर तो ब्रिटिशर्स ऑल्सो हैव सम काइंड ऑफ टेल्स कि दिस एट्रोसिटीज वर कमिटेड बाई द इंडियन रूलर्स ऑन अस ब्लैक होल इंसिडेंट्स दे विल ग्लोरीफाई दैट वी टुक रिवेंज ऑफ द ब्लैक होल इंसिडेंट एंड देन आर रॉबर्ट क्लाइव ही डिफीटेड द बंगाल नवाब राइट तो इनिशियली दे विल फ्ली बट लेटर ऑन they will call reinforcements from Madras. They are a strong navy. So this was the short-sightedness of the Bengal Nawab. He didn't destroy their navy. Unki navy destroy karna important tha. Later on, they will meet in Plassey, 1757. And the Britishers will employ diplomacy. Jo unka major, unka commander-in-chief hoga, Mir Jafar. They will connive with him and he will come to the side of the Britishers. Unka jo chief treasury hoga, Rai Durlab, wo bhi idhar aa jayega. Jagat Seth ek important. To jitne bhi major important, those important functionaries will be there under the rule of Siraj ud Dawla. They all will come under the British influence. And the Battle of Plassey actually will be won without any fight. Without any fight. Most of the fight will be done by the Siraj ud Dawla army only and they will do most of the dying also. So political mastery will not take place over Plassey. The British will master Plassey, 1757. Right? 1757 mein abhi important British functionary hai Robert Clive. Robert Clive. His name will come again when we'll do the Anglo-French rivalry. The Anglo-French rivalry in the first two wars, the French will be victorious. But later on, jab Clive aayega, then the tables will turn. So Clive is important. So Robert Clive will be there. Then Mir Jafar will become the Nawab. Theek hai na? Obviously, kuch toh milega usse. But after 2 years, he will also feel suffocated. And there will be some successor, Mir Qasim. He will be made the Nawab. When Mir Qasim will come to the throne, he will also realize ke what nonsense is going on here. I am not actually the Nawab. I am just a puppet. And he will try to take some steps like he will completely abolish inland trade. Wo kahega, bhai, trading system ab aisa ho gaya hai ki Britishers ko fayda ho raha hai. Aur jo Indian merchants hai, they are at loss. They are being made to pay taxes on passage of goods. Their goods have become expensive. So he will say कि चलो सबका abolish कर दो यार खत्म करो British तो वैसे ही नहीं दे रहे कम से कम Indian merchants को तो कुछ फायदा हो but these steps will be not in favor of the British they will again see it as an attack on their administration तो Mir Qasim then will go to the Nawab of Awadh Shuja ud Dawla now what is the interest of Nawab of Awadh उस बंदे का क्या interest है Obviously, the spread of the British rule has reached in his territory also. The British are even levying taxes on those merchants who are staying in the territory of Awadh. Awadh is basically modern-day UP. Most of the even area under modern-day UP, it was under Awadh. So, he also wants that if I take part in this in this war. Maybe after the war, I can have some kind of influence over Bengal. Bengal was the richest area at that time. So everybody wants to share of the pie. So he helped Mir Qasim, Shuja-ud-Dawla and the French. They will now fight the Battle of Buxar in 1764. Now this is an important event because here there will be actual fighting done by the British Army. And here all the three forces, they will be humiliated by the British. All of the three forces, combined forces, they will be humiliated. And afterwards, Britishers will not annex Awadh. Annex nahi karenge jaise Bengal ko kiya. Why? What could be the reason?
What? Because they have to rule over them, which that they were not interested in ruling over.
Why?
They wanted profit. They were basically business, but they didn't want to
move. One reason is this. Any other reason? Too much of rivalry, too much of revenue. ज़्यादा पैसा आएगा तो पागल हो जाएंगे कि क्या करें हम.
No sir, the revenue source is Bengal and there will be a lot of unrest in our
they didn't want that. So they want to extort money from the Nawabs.
Okay, 1761, third battle of Panipat is there. So Abdali was there. Alright, so there is influence from the west also. So if they extend their frontiers till Awadh, they will come directly under the conflict with the western invasions. Ek to ye reason hai. Then also, they are a trading company. They are a trading company. If they will acquire so much political power so soon, they will come under the scanner of the British Parliament. Kahenge, boss, ye toh hero hi ban gaye wahan jaake. Wahan trading karne gaye the, boss ban gaye. So they will try to exert some kind of influence. Baad mein se regulating act aayega 1773. Right? What else? What could be the other reason? Still there are some other European powers there, though they have been sidelined. Right? Pondicherry mein French hain, Goa mein Portuguese hain. And they recognize the Mughal supremacy. So there was a fear also ki maybe if they'll usurp or annex slowly and steadily all the Mughal states, so the other European powers, they will refuse ke why we should obey the Britishers, we obey the Mughals. So fir kuch rivalry shuru ho sakti hai. Right? Got it? Now their strategy is to stay, to lay low. Don't attract attention. They have Bengal there. Enough revenues are there. They need to farm it out first. Fir Awadh ko buffer state rakhenge. Later on we'll see the relationship of the British with the princely states, evolving relationship. Pehle kya relationship tha, fir kya tha. So we will see a pattern ki kya kya pattern tha unka, right? So what you are saying na ki political influence zyada ho jayega. So because of that, usko hi extend aap karoge, that will have some effect on their rule also. So that is why they didn't annex Awadh, right? Ab Awadh ko annex nahi kiya hai, what next they need to do? Now, in 1765, by 1765 they have Bengal, they have Awadh, though it is indirectly under their rule. Now they will establish dual government. 1765, dual government. What? Why they didn't annex Awadh? Okay, Awadh ko kisliye nahi annex kiya? Because they want to have a some kind of distance from the western influences. Pehla to ye hai jo western invasions ho rahi hain. Then second is British Parliament ke under nahi aana chahte, scanner ke under nahi aana chahte. Too much political power, maybe the British Parliament will take over the East India Company. Third is, other European powers, they may refuse to recognize the supremacy of the British, or they will not obey the British. They may even gang up against the Britishers, right? that major prominent reasons are this only. Now, under dual government 1765, what they'll do is the Diwani rights. Diwani means land revenue. Those rights will be the of the British in Bengal, and other rights like law and order, jo nizamat rights hain. One is the Diwani rights and other is the nizamat rights. Jo kaam kaaj wala sara kaam hai, police work, judicial work, law and order maintenance, those activities are under the control of Nawab. So they will establish dual government there, right? So isse kya fayda hona hai? Yes, money without responsibility, power without responsibility, you can say. And one more point, jo abhi humne likhwaya hai ki British Parliament ke under nahi aa jayenge na, because they are not the political masters here. Political masters to Nawab hi abhi bhi Bengal ka. Now they are working behind the scenes, right? Kuch points likh lo ispe, write some points. Justification for dual system. Many of these justifications will be similar to the justifications for not annexing Awadh. Similar, right? Abhi unka role kya hai? Abhi wo bachche hain yaar, they are bachche. Wo baap ban ke dikhayenge to fir pel diye jayenge dobara. So they want to stay low. That is their motive. That should be the motive of a civil servant also. You should not unnecessarily show your power. Ki bhai main to bahut bada insaan hu. Show your power where it is necessary. And that is the basic quality also of a civil servant, anonymity. Ethics paper 4 mein hai na, GS ethics paper 4, anonymity. You should be anonymous. If you'll go to a district and you'll ask, or a constituency will ask ki, who is the MP or MLA, you will know the name. But if you'll ask who is the DC or DM, ya SP kaun hai, nahi pata hoga. SP shayad pata ho, DM jata nahi pata hoga, aam insaan ko. Because that is the quality of a civil servant. You should be anonymous. All right, right? First point. Open assumption. This is justification for dual system. Open assumption of authority. Open assumption of authority may have resulted in the unity of the Indian princes. May have resulted in the unity of Indian princes against the British. Second, British Parliament may have interfered with EIC. Short mein likhwa raha hu ekdam. Third point. What did you write? East India Company, EIC. Kya yehi doubt tha? British Parliament may have interfered in EIC working, East India Company working. Third point, other European powers may not have acknowledged British authority. Last point, EIC was more interested in financial and commercial gains rather than territorial acquisitions. All right. Put a next heading, constitutional development. Now initially 1773 से शुरू होगा आपका फर्स्ट रेगुलेटिंग एक्ट, देन बोर्ड ऑफ कंट्रोल विल बी एस्टेब्लिश इन पिट्स इंडिया एक्ट. तो सम काइंड ऑफ डेवलपमेंट विल गो ऑन, तो विल सी दोज डेवलपमेंट्स. इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स हम नोट कर लेंगे. कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन डेवलपमेंट फर्स्ट रेगुलेटिंग एक्ट ऑफ 1773. फर्स्ट पॉइंट, इट अपॉइंटेड अ गवर्नर जनरल, इट अपॉइंटेड जीजी प्लस फोर काउंसिल मेंबर्स. गवर्नर जनरल प्लस फोर काउंसिल मेंबर्स इन कैलकटा एज द हाईएस्ट एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव अथॉरिटी. एज द हाईएस्ट एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव अथॉरिटी. नेक्स्ट, सुप्रीम कोर्ट एस्टैब्लिश्ड. सुप्रीम कोर्ट एस्टैब्लिश्ड एट कैलकटा इन 1774, कंप्राइजिंग वन चीफ जस्टिस एंड थ्री अदर जस्टिसेस. लास्ट पॉइंट, प्रेसिडेंसीज ऑफ बॉम्बे एंड मद्रास सबॉर्डिनेटेड टू कैलकटा प्रेसिडेंसी. ठीक है, दीज आर द फोर मेजर पॉइंट्स. नेक्स्ट इज द पिट्स इंडिया एक्ट 1784. इसमें से मेजर पॉइंट क्या निकाल के ले जाओगे, व्हाट इज द टेक अवे? बोर्ड ऑफ कंट्रोल कम इन पिट्स इंडिया एक्ट 1784. 1773 में व्हाट इज द टेक अवे? यस, गवर्नर जनरल इज देयर, सुप्रीम कोर्ट इज देयर, राइट? सो दीज आर द इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट्स. All right, 1784 Pitts India Act. First point is Board of Control having 6 members, out of which Board of Control having 6 members, out of which 2 were cabinet members. Two were cabinet members. So now this is the major point of this act. क्योंकि अब British Parliament का कुछ stake हो गया, ठीक है ना? तो always differentiate कि what changes are going on as we go further. Next point, it authorized Court of Directors to make all recruitments in India. It authorized Court of Directors to make all recruitments in India. Last point, Supreme Court meant for only British subjects. आई एम जस्ट गिविंग यू द इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट. 36 पॉइंट हैं इस एक्ट पे, सारे इम्पॉर्टेंट नहीं है. वी ओनली नीड टू नो वॉट आर द यूनिक आस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ एवरी एक्ट. नाउ नेक्स्ट एक्ट इज 1813 चार्टर एक्ट. नाउ हेयर देर आर 3 इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स. पहला बता दो कोई, इट इज रिगार्डिंग ट्रेड, मोनोपोली इन इंडिया, ट्रेड विद इंडिया हैज बीन स्टॉप्ड एक्सेप्ट फॉर टी, बट चाइना के साथ अभी भी चल रहा है. चाइना के साथ दे फॉट ओपियम वॉर्स इन 1839. पहला ओपियम वॉर हुआ, तो व्हाई वाज द वॉर वर्ल्ड हिस्ट्री में? ओपियम वॉज ग्रोन इन इंडिया, ठीक है, एंड एक्सपोर्टेड इन चाइना. व्हाई दे यूज टू एक्सपोर्ट ओपियम देयर? पैसे भी तो दे सकते हो. पैसे क्यों नहीं देते थे, ओपियम क्यों देते थे? यस, ट्रेड बैलेंस. देयर वाज नो मार्केट फॉर ब्रिटिश गुड्स इन चाइना, तो पैसे दे देंगे तो कंगाल हो जाएंगे. तो दैट इज़ वाई दे थॉट कि कुछ ऐसा करते हैं, यहाँ से उगाएंगे और वहाँ भेज देंगे. ओपीएम, दे यूज टू पे फॉर द स्टफ दे बॉट फ्रॉम चाइना थ्रू ओपीएम, राइट. एंड लेटर ऑन ओपीएम वॉर्स में क्या हुआ, फिर दे लॉस्ट, द चाइनीज लॉस्ट, ब्रिटिशर्स वॉन, एंड देन दे ओपन्ड देयर मार्केट, दे गेव देम टेरिटोरियल राइट्स ऑल्सो. उसके बाद बाकी यूरोपियन पावर्स ने भी वॉर किया सिमिलरली, राइट. एंड देन इट लेड टू कटिंग ऑफ द चाइनीज मेलन, सब ने आके कुछ कुछ पोर्शंस अपना ले लिया, राइट. उसके बाद जापानीज, दे विल मोस्ट ऑफ द इंपीरियलिस्ट एग्रेशन ऑफ जापानीज इट विल डायरेक्टेड टुवर्ड्स चाइना ओनली. दैट इज वाई दैट इज द हिस्टोरिकल ग्रीवांस ऑफ द चाइनीज. तभी उन दोनों के बीच में इतनी कटती है, राइट. जापानीज, दे हैव डन ट्रिमेंडस रॉन्ग टू चाइनीज, ट्रिमेंडस रॉन्ग. 1931 दे इन्वेडेड मंचूरिया, इन 1937 फुल फ्लेज्ड इन्वेजन कर दिया. वर्ल्ड हिस्ट्री में आपने पढ़ा होगा क्यों किया 1937 में, व्हाई डिड दे इन्वेडेड, देयर मस्ट बी सम रीजन फॉर इट ना. 1935 हिटलर रीमिलिटराइज्ड राइनलैंड. 1936 इटली इन्वेडेड इथोपिया. तो कुछ कुछ कर रहे हैं बाकी फासिस्ट स्टेट. तो जापान इज थिंकिंग वाई शुड आई बी लेफ्ट आउट, मैं भी कुछ करता हूँ. तो 1937 एंड इट मुसोलिनी ऑल्सो इन्वेडेड इथोपिया बिकॉज ऑफ हिटलर्स एंटिक्स. हिटलर वॉज बिकमिंग वेरी सक्सेसफुल इट इट्स पॉलिसीज. इनिशियली इटली वॉज अगेंस्ट हिटलर ना, यू मस्ट नो. जर्मनी के अगेंस्ट था इटली, बट लेटर ऑन जब उसने देखा कि यार दे आर अपीजिंग हिटलर, तो वाई शुड आई बी द गुड गाय, आई शुड ऑल्सो डू समथिंग बैड. तो जापानीज एग्रेशन अगेंस्ट चाइनीज, ये चल रहा है पूरा. तो ओपीएम वॉर से भी लिंक कर सकते हो, पूरा हमें पता लग जाएगा. ऑल राइट, फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज रिगार्डिंग ट्रेड. तो कमर्शियल मोनोपोली एंडेड इन इंडिया एक्सेप्ट फॉर टी एंड ट्रेड विद चाइना. फर्स्ट पॉइंट तो ट्रेड का हो गया. सेकेंड पॉइंट इज रिगार्डिंग एजुकेशन. These are the unique points. 1 lakh rupee sanction to promote education in India 1813. So if when we'll do the education topic na, wahan dekhenge hum. 1813 shuru hua. Then 1835 Macaulay's minute. Then 1854 Wood's dispatch. So for everything, for every topic we'll make a story. Ke bahut shuru se shuru karte hain, what the story is. So 1813 1 lakh rupee sanction. Then next point is regarding religion. Christian missionaries were allowed to come to British India and preach their religion. ठीक है, तो 1813 when they'll come, that is why there will be growth of social religious reform movements. Later on we'll see. So every event has a cause. जैसे बुद्धा का एक चार नोबल ट्रूथ में से एक नोबल ट्रूथ है ना, चार आर्य सत्य हैं ये बुद्धा के. फर्स्ट इज देर इज सफरिंग इन द वर्ल्ड. डू एग्री, एस्पेशली फॉर सिविल सर्वेंट्स, देर इज सफरिंग इन द वर्ल्ड. देन देर इज अ कॉज फॉर सफरिंग. कॉज इज यू वॉन्ट टू बिकम अ सिविल सर्वेंट एंड देर इज एन एंड टू द सफरिंग. एंड इज वेन यू बिकम द सिविल सर्वेंट. And there is a path through which you can end this suffering. Buddha ke liye nirvana hai, hamare liye ye sab hai jo modern Indian history aur culture ye sab padhna hai. All right. So these are the three unique points. Then next is Charter Act of 1833. Again, first point is complete end of EIC monopoly with India. Complete end of trade monopoly with India for EIC. Pura khel khatam inka. Now because of this, what will happen? Hamare liye achha hai ki bura hai? For our Indians, for us Indians, bura hai. Abhi to ek loot raha tha ke East India Company. Now everyone will loot us. All of the British companies will come and loot us. Because for us, trade barriers are there. हमारे प्रोडक्ट तो महंगे हैं वहां पर, बट देयर प्रोडक्ट्स विल नाउ बिकम चीपर. वी लूज आवर मार्केट्स इन इंडिया ऑल्सो. First is this. Second is, very important, Governor General of Bengal made as the Governor General of India. So first was Lord William Bentinck, likh lo. Governor General of Bengal made as the Governor General of India. Lord Bentinck. ब्रैकेट में उसका टाइम पीरियड लिख लो 80 फ्रॉम 1828. थर्ड पॉइंट 1828 टू 1834 राइट. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट द एग्जीक्यूटिव काउंसिल. द एग्जीक्यूटिव काउंसिल was enlarged through the addition of one law member. Initially there was a Governor General Council, later on usko thoda trim down karke GG plus 3 kar diya tha. Now again it has been made GG plus 4, one law member has been added. Next point, appointment of law commission in India. This law commission will lead to codification of laws. Would be important. Appointment of law commission in India, later on, unified, uniform and codified law system was created in India. ठीक है? Next is Charter Act of 1853. First point, Charter Act 1853. सारे ये हैं, इसमें से इंपॉर्टेंट पिट्स इंडिया है आपका विच कैन बी आस्क्ड राइट. 1813 वाला इंपॉर्टेंट है एंड देन 1858 इंपॉर्टेंट है. इन प्रीलिम्स यूपीएससी विल आस्क ओनली द इंपॉर्टेंट वंस. इफ यू सी द प्रीवियस ईयर पेपर्स, लास्ट ईयर पेपर 1919 दे आस्क्ड राइट. बट वी मस्ट नो द स्टोरी. स्टोरी पता होगी तो सब याद करना आसान है. फर्स्ट पॉइंट अंडर चार्टर एक्ट 1853, फर्दर एडिशन ऑफ 6 मेंबर्स to GG Council making it a body for legislative purposes, converting it into a body for legislative purposes. 6 members were Chief Justice and a sitting judge of Supreme Court, CGI, sitting judge of Supreme Court, plus 4 representatives from Bengal, Madras, Bombay and NWFP. अभी गवर्नर जनरल जो बना है आपके 1833 एक्ट में, Governor General of India is still the Governor of Bengal. Later on, the Governor General of India will be separated from Governor General of Bengal. Jab Dalhousie aayega 1848. So these are the things which you should look out for in prelims. In pe question bante hain, right? Next, Indian Civil Services became an open competition. Macaulay was made chairman of Indian Civil Services Committee. Macaulay, M-A-C-A-U-L-A-Y. Macaulay is a very important personality. जो English educated होते हैं, generally उनको बोल देते हैं कभी-कभी, जलील करने के लिए, Macaulay Putras. Because Macaulay's minute in 1835, it is known as the beginning of English education in India. Alright, तो जो important events हो, उनको हमेशा याद रखो. Yeah. All right. Indian Civil Service became open. Macaulay made chairman of Indian Civil Services Committee. Written exam started in 1854. Next point, for the first time, 1854, Written examination 1854. Next point. For the first time, local representation introduced in legislative council. Local legislative. Local representation introduced in legislative council. Right? So this is regarding the charter. Abhi humne 1853 tak dekh liya. Initially, Governor General plus four members banaya, right? Uske baad they removed one member in between. Then later on, they added one member as law member.
There were five members, including Governor General plus four council members. Then they got six members.
Six members came in 1850?
In 1734.
Six members. Governor General plus six members, that is in 1853, legislative councils.
Pitts India
mein toh board of control established hua na. Board of, achha dekho, tum confused hoge, sorry. Board of control India mein nahi hai. Board of control Britain mein hai. Toh board of control ye hai. Aur India mein Governor General plus four initially hai. Theek hai na? Ye confusion ho sakti hai. So this is in India, this is in Britain. Later on, what will happen, this board of control will be replaced by Secretary of State. ठीक है ना, Secretary of State हो जाएगा, और इन लोगों को ये अभी autonomous हैं, right? Nominal, they are under the nominal head of the Britain. But later on, inko replace karke, they will directly come under crown through the Secretary of State. Crown upar hoga, Secretary of State, Governor General. Right?
Now they will have six members plus
the. Ye to 1858 Act hai. 1853 mein, later on, Governor General plus 3 plus 1, 1813 mein remove karenge, phir law member aayega yahan par. And in 1853, Governor General plus 4 plus 6 members, then it will function as a legislative council. Right? ठीक है? Court of Directors are in Britain. Company के director Britain में ही है. Court of Directors have been formed initially, एकदम शुरू में कंपनी को तो वही चला रहे हैं ना. Later on, Britain 1773 में कुछ आएगा. Got it? Board of Control, Court of Directors, Secretary of State, ये सब Britain में. हमारे देश में क्या है? Governor General. Later on, it will transform into Imperial Council. फिर provinces में provincial councils बनेंगे. 1935 Act में. This is the relationship. And it will continue till 1935. The provinces will come under the Central Imperial Council. Later on, the development will happen. ठीक है? अभी भी subordinate है ना? The other provinces are subordinate. This is initial position. This is 1858 position. Later on in 1935, what will happen? Crown will give the power to the center as well as the provinces. So now provinces will not be under the center. They will be under directly the crown. Ye position change hogi 1935. So these are the three distinct arrangements of the British administrative rule in India. Here initially they are under court of director. Then after 1858 they will be under Secretary of State, British crown. And later on in 1935 they will be under crown, but center in provinces. Separately, they will be under the crown. Separate kyun kar diya? Kuch reason hoga? 1935 Act mein, why did they put them separately? Provincial autonomy was one of the recommendations of Simon Commission. What is the reason behind it? All India Federation, they are proposed, right? Is there a political motive behind it?
Muslim people also like, you get the power.
Basically, INC is the national level head of this movement, and they are at power in the center. So they wanted ke provinces ko autonomy denge, maybe some leadership will emerge, which will then challenge the INC at center. Tabhi provincial autonomy di hai. It is not because of some benevolence or love for federalism. It is to balkanize India. That was the reason for this change in the constitution structure. Got it? Theek hai, it's clear?
Yes.
Chalo. Now let's come to some institutions. He was a British cabinet minister. Secretary of State nahi hota, foreign minister. Wohi tha wo.
So he was basically from House of
Lords. Yes, yes. Jaise US mein hota na, Secretary of State. To wo tha wo. All right. Hanji? What? This is for British India. British India, British Empire, jo bhi hai British Empire mein. Latin America mein hai, Central America mein hai, Central Asia mein hai, whatever is there, it is under the, right? Theek hai?
Sir, here we said that we enlarged the governor, the executive council by one member. There, in this representation, you said governor general plus 3 plus 1. So it should be governor general plus 4, which we earlier added, plus 1 law member.
Actually, in Pitts India Act, they removed one member. Usko kam kar diya tha, right? To usko fir baad mein add kar diya, as a law member. ठीक है, एनी अदर क्वेश्चंस? ऑलराइट, लेट्स मूव ऑन. चलो, नाउ द ब्रिटिशर्स की कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन डेवलपमेंट हमने देख ली, ड्यूअल सिस्टम देख लिया. नाउ नेक्स्ट एस्पेक्ट कम्स सम इंस्टीट्यूशंस दे हैड एस्टैब्लिश्ड, लाइक लैंड रेवेन्यू सिस्टम, पुलिस, सिविल सर्विसेज, जुडिशरी. ऑलराइट, तो ये एस्पेक्ट हमने देखे. इसमें से मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट इज लैंड रेवेन्यू सिस्टम. Now before Cornwallis, Cornwallis will come in 1786. Before him, Warren Hastings was there, first Governor General of India. But Cornwallis ke time pe jo system tha na, it was very impractical. Highest bidder ko de rakha tha land. Who bids the highest, he will be given, and from that some share will be there of the Britishers. Auction system tha. It was very inefficient because unrealistic auctions were there, and when that rent could not be collected, then evictions used to happen. So it was inefficient. Cornwallis then introduced permanent land revenue system in 1793. Permanent land revenue system, uska main is the zamindari system. Because zamindari system, it was established in Bengal, Bihar, Orissa, in these areas, on the northeastern areas, jahan par pehle initially they were there. Later on, jaise south mein enter karenge, to wahan par kuch system establish karenge, like the Rathwari system. And then, when they will annex Punjab in 1849, wahan par Mahalwari karenge. So all these three systems, zamindari, Rathwari, Mahalwari. What is their objective? Bhala karna kisano ka? They don't give a damn ki mare jiye, aaj kal mar rahe hain, aaj mar jaye. Their basic purpose is to collect as much revenue as possible and constant revenue, stable revenue. Aisa na ho ki अगले साल बहुत कम आया, किसी साल बहुत ज़्यादा है. दे वॉन्ट स्टेबल रेवेन्यू एंड दे वॉन्ट मैक्सिमम रेवेन्यू. दैट इज देयर पर्पस. सो फर्स्ट विल बी द जमींदारी, राइट? व्हाट? जमींदारी सिस्टम होगा. इन जमींदारी द जमींदार्स, दे विल बी द पर्सन्स विद हुम द ब्रिटिश विल कम इन टू engagement, arrangement ki bhai itna revenue hai, they will fix the revenue as 89% of the rent, and it will be fixed for a period of 10 years, ki 10 saal ke liye revenue fix hai, uske baad dobara will renegotiate. And the zamindars, then they will further sublet it to the small peasant. Small peasant niche rayat ko dega, So this will be the system there, zamindari system. The zamindars, they will be recognized as the owners of the land, right? So because the Europeans, unko system ka pata nahi hai itna, right? So they think that they are only the owners of the land. So because of this, zamindari system will be there. The intermediaries, the zamindars, they will rise, they will become powerful. Later on in Rotwari system in the south, there will be no intermediaries. Koi zamindars nahi hoge wahan par, feudal lords. Like there was feudal lord system in feudalism na, in Europe. Waisa koi system nahi hai. So there the Britishers will directly engage with the Rohits. Here the zamindar will be the British. They will directly engage with the Rohits. And in Mahalwari system, in the northwest part of India, there the ownership will be collective. Mahal, matlab mahal is basically 3-4 villages ke groups ko bol dete hai, mahal. So there the arrangements will be made with elders of the villages. Jo village elders honge, jaise panch honge, yes, jo senior fellows honge, unke saath they will make the arrangements. Lumberdar hote hain jo. Lumberdar jo hote hain aapke gaon mein, the head of the village. So un sab ke saath arrangement kar liya ki, boss, now you are responsible. Collectively you have to pay this much amount. Right? So in Mahalwari, here the zamindars are the persons with whom arrangements have been made. Here with the Rohits and here with the Mahals, the elders, village elders, Lumberdars, the Panch. For Britishers, this was the most efficient, Zamindar. Right? After that, Mahalwari. Area wise, this is northeast, eastern and northeastern, right? Bihar, Orissa, Bengal. अच्छा the area of extent, this was maximum, right? And this was minimum. Because in south क्या था? In south there are princely states who are not under Britishers. They are under the subsidiary line system. भाई वेलेसली का subsidiary line system देखेंगे. And then this one, Mahalwari system. Right? So the most dominant one, तभी आप देखोगे question जो ज़्यादा बनते हैं, वो ज़मींदारी system पे ही बनते हैं. Yes, please ask. Yes, all of them were permanent settlement only. Different forms of permanent settlement system.
For the same period,
10 years. Yes, periods were different. Here it was 10 years, here it was 30 years, right? Different differences.
But permanent settlement was fixed for months.
For a time period it was fixed, na? Ki itne 10 saal ke liye itna hai. After that they will renegotiate. Got it? भाई अब 100 साल के लिए थोड़ी कर लेंगे कि भाई तुम 100 साल तक इतना दोगे. They want periodic revision. तो permanent settlement signifies के year on year जो fluctuations है ना, that have been tackled. That is the motive of permanent settlement system. So if a question comes in prelims, permanent settlement system was constituted for to improve agriculture output, all right, to invest in irrigation. Though this was also one of the intent. Maybe because of permanent settlement system, jo surplus milega royat ko ya peasant ko ya zamindar ko, they will invest it back in the agriculture, irrigation improve karenge. But that didn't happen because bahut kam bachta tha peasants ko, right? So as analytical questions also that can come. For example, in 2012 a question came in Rohitwari system. Rohits were the owners of the land. Patta, jo land ka patta hota tha, it was in their name. So it is correct statement. In Rohitwari system, peasants were owners of the land. In Mahalwari system also, the peasants were owners of the land. Though revenue was collected collectively, but in Zamindari system, they were not. Right? Zamindars were the intermediaries there. Got it? Theek hai? Write some points, some basic points. Yes. ownership was with the riots. Riot मतलब peasant को बोलते हैं रियोत, ठीक है? क्योंकि यहाँ पर intermediates नहीं है ना, तो British is the biggest जमींदार. All right. Right, permanent settlement system. First point. Bengal, Bihar, Orissa. These points you can get in book also, right? ये permanent settlement देख लेना. Right for police. इसको लिख लेना बाद में permanent settlement. These are the main points. Right for police. Next institution. Police. In 1791, Cornwallis established. Cornwallis came in 1786. So you must be aware of some important governor generals also. Unke time mein kya important hua hai, you must be aware. There are only 10 to 12 important governor generals. Sab nahi yaad karne. Right? Warren Hastings hai initially wala. Cornwallis ne kuch kuch kiya hai. Wellesley ke under kuch hua hai. Irwin hai, Curzon hai, Mountbatten hai. राइट ज़्यादा ज़्यादा लोग इम्पॉर्टेंट नहीं हैं बस, बट जो इम्पॉर्टेंट हैं उनका यू मस्ट बी वेरी मच केयरफुल. ऑल राइट, 1791 कॉर्नवालिस इंट्रोड्यूस रेगुलर पुलिस फोर्स टू मेंटेन लॉ एंड ऑर्डर. ही एस्टैब्लिश्ड थानास इन अ डिस्ट्रिक्ट अंडर अ दरोगा. दरोगा इज बेसिकली, अभी क्या होता है दरोगा को क्या बोलते हैं, एसएचओ. दरोगा जो थाने का हेड होता है, एसएचओ. ही एस्टैब्लिश थानास इन अ डिस्ट्रिक्ट अंडर अ दरोगा एंड द हेड ऑफ द डिस्ट्रिक्ट वॉज अ एसपी. थाना वॉज अंडर दरोगा एंड हेड ऑफ द डिस्ट्रिक्ट वॉज एन एसपी, सुपरिटेंडेंट ऑफ पुलिस. ही रिलीव्ड द जमींदार्स of their police duty. Relieved the zamindars of their police duty. Next point. Bentinck abolished the office of SP. Bentinck came in 1828. Bentinck abolished the office of SP and vested the collector or the magistrate with and vested the collector or the magistrate with police powers. With police powers. Next is civil services. Civil services, first point. The office of district collector was created for the first time by Lord Warren Hastings in 1771. Lord Warren Hastings in 1771. Cornwallis is regarded as the father of Indian civil service, as he formulated a code of conduct, as he formulated a code of conduct, reformed the pay system with tankha proper honi chahiye. तभी सेवेंथ पे कमीशन भी आता है, एवरी फाइव इयर्स देयर इज. ही फॉर्मुलेटेड कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट, रिफॉर्म्ड द पे सिस्टम, एस्टैब्लिश्ड प्रोसीजर्स फॉर देयर प्रमोशन, एस्टैब्लिश्ड प्रोसीजर्स फॉर देयर प्रमोशन इन 18 नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इन 1800 इन 1800 Wellesley, Wellesley. Wellesley. In 1800, Wellesley started civil services training in Fort William. Civil services training in Fort William. Usi mein same point. In 1806, the college was replaced by Haileybury College in London. Civil services became open in 1853 Charter Act. Mein first examinations took place in 1854. So before that, there was this college here. So it became very difficult for Indians to become civil servants. Training bhi nahi hai yahan par, paper dene bhi bahar jana hai. Later on, they will decrease age also. 19 kar denge. Abhi bhi chal raha hai kuch kuch. Jaldi nikal lo. Age kab parak hum, nobody knows. In 1853, civil services were opened for all through a written examination. Right? Now let's see the British relationship. How the British power has grown. Cornwallis did this. Later on, Baltic combined. Right? Now let's see the British. British ke rule ko hum kaise divide kar sakte hain? Tell me one important event. 1608 se leke next date, what should I write? Buxar likh lete hain. Right? So this event categorizes the British rule as what? They were a trading company and they are fighting with other European powers for supremacy. Kuch kuch chal raha hai, they were fighting for political power. Next period is 1764 to 1818 by Third Anglo-Maratha War. Now they have become a major political power in India. Here the fight is with other European powers. Here is the fight with princely states. Ladai jhagda chal raha hai. Marathas bhi khatam ho gaye. Mughals to waisi hi khalas ho chuke hain. Now they have become the major power. Now from 1818 to 1857, right? What is the characteristic of British rule here? Bhai, they are the boss. Boss kya karega? Bully karega? They will bully everyone. Subsidiary line system. Bhaiya, tum British resident rakho, ye karo, wo karo. They will annex everything. They will annex Satara first. Right? Interference with culture. That will start in Charter Act of? Here we are seeing the political growth, right? Theek hai. So here they are, 1857 se, next is, kab tak? 1935, and from 1935 till 1947. So here they are, struggle for equality is there. This whole period marks. Right? Then you can say here policy of ring fence is there. Wellesley will come as the Governor General in 1798 and he will introduce a subsidiary alliance system. Subsidiary alliance system. Under that system, he will ask Hyderabad, Awadh, can you please keep some army of us, standing army of us in your area, it will protect you against foreign invasion. And then they will say, keep a British resident also. It will advise you. He will advise you on important policy decisions. And they will say, but please don't engage in any foreign relations with some other powers without our consent. So foreign policy, you please give it to us. Right? So why they are doing this? Wellesley started it when he arrived here after 1798. Tell me some important event in world history, 1789.
French
Revolution. After that, 1803, Napoleon becomes the emperor. So Napoleon will introduce the continental system also in Europe. Basically, wants to isolate the Britishers. Unko target kar rahe hain. So Britishers ka sabse prized position kya hai? India. India pe capture kar liya Napoleon ne, to game khalas. So that is why Wellesley is trying to cultivate loyalty in the areas neighboring to the British rule. Jo buffer states hai, wahan par political favor create kar raha hai. So that is why this subsidiary alliance system is there. Then in 1818, Third Anglo-Maratha War, the British have become the dominant. Now they will try to bully everyone. Isko annex kar, usko annex kar. Annexation policies will happen, right? From 1818 till 1857. What was the last princely state which was annexed in 1856? Awadh. Right, that is why the mutiny happened, because that is a major reason for the mutiny. Though there is the event of greased cartridges also. Ke pig fat hai, ye fat hai wo. But main reason was, ek to they had their own grievances. And also, 3/4 of the soldiers in the British army, they were from Awadh. So when Awadh was annexed in 1856, their sentiments are being evoked, right? Now, after 1857, what happens? Direct rule. Now they will not annex anyone. Policy of annexation will be dropped. And consolidation will be there. So basically, this policy is similar to this policy, subsidiary alliance wala. Okay, now they say, we'll go back to that same policy that was working fine. Why we are going for annexation and direct rule, that is absolute nonsense. Now again, they will adopt this approach, ki boss, foreign policy leke rakho and control them through strings, make them puppets. And later on, this period will be there. This period will mark 1935 Act, most unique thing. Federation. So right. So here they will say federation. Okay, let's now integrate everyone into a federation. The princely states, the Indian states, everyone into a federation. That will be the aim. So this is the characteristic of the British rule. Hum aise usko analyze kar sakte. All right. So now some important dates automatically we will be able to remember, like 1608, 1764 Buxar. 1818, Third Anglo-Maratha War, 1857, Mutiny, 1935, it is like this, right? So this is the whole story of their rule in India. Got it? Alright, just write few words on this. British policy in India. First is 1608 to 1764. Policy, struggle for equality. Struggle for equality for the EIC, East India Company. Struggle for equality, matlab. यहाँ पर लड़ाई झगड़ा चल रहा है ना with the European powers and also some conflict has started with the princely states. एक को तो कब्जे में कर लिया, बाकियों को भी कब्जे में कर लेंगे, right? So now they, from an trading company they are now want, they want to become a political power. So that is struggle for equality. Next is from 1764 to 1818 emergence as the dominant political power in India. Marathas kabhi, what was the main cause for downfall of the Marathas?
Internal feuds.
Internal feuds, very important point, right? And also they had the same weaknesses which marred the Mughal Empire also later on. Ek unka jagirdari system hota tha Mughals mein, ki jo jahan jeeta usko jagir de di utni, nobles ko. Same kind of system was with the Maratha Sardar or Saranjami system. To Sardar, wo to aur mahan the. The Nawabs would actually take control of that area, right? Jo jagirs mili unhe, and they used to establish some kind of revenue settlement wahan. But jo Maratha Sardar se deve se ki okay, tum karo jo kar rahe ho pehle se, bas hume paise pahuncha dena. They didn't even rule the, directly that state. So that was the cause. Revenue, jab tak finances strong nahi honge na, you cannot rule a strong empire. Military will become strong only through finances, revenue. Alright, 1764 to 1818 is emergence as the dominant political power. Then 1818 to 1857, policy of annexations and usurpation of Indian states. Then from 1857 to 1935, policy of annexation and usurpation of usurpation. usurpation. Usurpation मतलब कब्जा कर लिया, usurp कर लेना, कजब कब्जा कर लेना. Usurpation of Indian states. Then from 1857 to 1935, policy of subordinate union. So now, similar policy there, subsidy lines ka, policy of subordinate union. So everyone is under the British and everyone is subordinate, though the British are not directly ruling. Then from 1935 to 1947, policy of subordinate federation. So ours is a federation or ours is a union. What is the difference between union separation? What is the difference between union and federation? Separation of powers is not the difference. States are autonomous in federation but not in union. How? So basically, if you have to summarize in one line, it is enough in a union, it is an indestructible union of destructible states. States don't have the right to secede, but in a federation, states have a right to secede. Right? That is the basic difference. So ours is a union. States have not come together. Union was first there, and then states have been given the autonomy. Alright. Now next point comes some economic impact of the British rule. In this economic impact, the main point is the drain theory. Drain theory is the important point. Wo hum baad mein dekhenge. Why? Because that is the most important contribution of moderates. If you see ke what moderates had done, there were some assumptions behind the British rule. First was that they are ruling for our favor. They are ruling for our favor. Moderates mein ye thodi parshani thi shuru mein, this confusion was there. And second was that British Empire cannot be defeated. So the first myth will be busted by the moderates through the economic drain theory. Ki bhai, they are not ruling for our favor. They are actually exploiting us. Right? And the second myth will be busted later on through mass movements. Ke British can be defeated. Alright, so first economic impact mein Britishers ka kya hoga? They introduced some modern telecommunication systems, modern communication systems. First, it is the postal system, postal. Postal introduced in 1837. So some say, like the Britishers, they are of the opinion ki actually we have forged the modern India. Tum to state the nation the hi nahi, humne banaya tumhe. What you are saying ki we ruled, you are not a nation. So in that, what the Britishers gave us, sabse important kya cheez di hai, dekho pehle ye princely state lad rahe hain aapas mein. Ab ekdam se beech mein ek common enemy aa gaya. Now they are all targeting this. Like we see in 1857 mutiny, pehle thodi aapas mein sab lad rahe the, jhansi aur ye sabke, they had personal fiefdoms. Now as soon as they got a common enemy, they have united. That is why when they raised Bahadur Shah Zafar as the emperor of India, uske baad confused ki what to do next, because they don't have a forward plan. They are not a nation. Unko pata nahi ab aage kya karna hai. Bahadur Shah Zafar bhi confused ki what to do next. And that is the reason why the Britishers took particular offense to the Muslims after 1857 mutiny. Ke you people are responsible. Unko achche se dabaya. Because they raised Bahadur Shah Zafar as the emperor. Whom the Britishers replaced? The Mughals. And again your resurgent of the Mughals is there. Ki bhai, you are the emperor. Tum unhi ko dobara khada kar rahe ho jinko humne haraya. So that is why they took particular offense against the Muslims. And the reason for 1857 mutiny. Alright. So Britishers ne ek hume common unity di. Then what else they did? What else they gave us? Chalo ye to communication systems hum dekh lenge. इसमें आ जाएगा, रेलवेज आ जाएगा. रेलवेज इन 1853, राइट. देन कैनाल सिस्टम इज देयर, देन टेलीग्राफ इज देयर. 1854 टेलीग्राफ इज देयर, फर्स्ट कैनाल बिल्ट बाय ब्रिटिशर्स 1854, द गैंजेस कैनाल. तो कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम्स दे हैव प्रोवाइडेड अस. व्हाट एल्स दे आर गिविंग अस? एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव मैकेनिज्म, वेरी गुड. Administrative mechanisms, administrative unity, you can say. What else they are giving us? Uske andar aa jayega administrative, police, ye sab, everything is there. Modern education, modern military tactics. Okay, it can come here only, right? Military ka de diya chalo. But this is very important. Modern education. Right? Huh? Linguistic unity. Okay, it can come under administration. Press actually were introduced by the Portuguese. They bought the press here. Portuguese aur bhi bahut kuch laya. Aloo bhi wahi laya. Chikku bhi wahi laya. To ye sab cheeze wo laya. Press also they bought in 1556. Achha, what else? Social reforms and offshoot of modern education. All right. So administrative unity, and it provided geographical unity. So all this will give rise to feeling of nationalism. Ki now, bhaiya, now we are a nation. Though we are still a nation in making, abhi bhi chal raha hai. Koi kar raha, Kashmir is not part of India. Some are saying this is not part of India. So still, it is a recurring problem with our country, and it will recur again. Why? Because our concept is not like the concept of the European states. They are nation states. They were nation first and then they became a state. Ours is a state nation. Hamare mein bahut chote chote states hain and who have come together to form a nation. So this problem will rise again and again. Whenever there will be vested interests who will try to utilize this diversity to promote their agenda, this problem will rise again and again. क्योंकि इट इज़ नॉट पॉसिबल. कोई पंजाबी है, कोई गुजराती है, कोई नॉर्थ ईस्ट से है. लॉजिकली नहीं होना चाहिए यूनिटी. लॉजिकली वी आर डिफरेंट नेशंस, बट दैट इज़ द प्रॉब्लम विच विल अकर अगेन एंड अगेन. सो दिस इज द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ द ब्रिटिशर्स. दे प्रोवाइडेड ऑल दिस मॉडर्न कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम्स, कैनाल. नाउ व्हाट वर द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ दिस कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम? क्या इम्पैक्ट हुआ? पैन इंडिया ओके देन व्हाट वर यू टेलिंग हाँ जी आप बताओ ट्रांसफर ऑफ आइडियाज ओके ट्रांसफर ऑफ आइडियाज व्हाट एल्स Okay. Transfer of ideas. All right. Then for industrial revolution, they are now reaching to every nook and corner of our country. So labor dhoond dhoond ke la rahe hain. Sabko factory mein lagayenge. Railways are reaching to the different corners. Canal system is there. Postal is there. So they have got now new labor, industrial revolution, industrial push will they'll get. Then they will get more markets. Har jagah jaake bechenge. They'll sell their products. Then any revolt is there that will be quelled because they have telegraph. Phatafat kiya, tuk 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 electrical signal diya. There, this problem is going on. Railways mein bithaya soldiers ko. Revolt will be suppressed. That is why in 1857 mutiny, many of these mutineers, they first disrupted the telegraph system. Ki pehle ise khatam karo, khabar nahi pahunchni chahiye. So they were smart also. So revolt will be suppressed. New markets, labors, transfer of ideas, pan-Indian system, right? Then what else? Economic misery will increase, especially for artisans, because their products will not be able to compete with the British products. Then textiles, they will suffer. Right? Artisans, textiles, they will suffer. Achha, ek toh they are not able to compete, the artisans. And what other reason is there for their misery? Yes. Princelies, they were the mere patronizers. Ab bhai kaun khareedta art? Ameer hi toh khareedta hai. Gareeb thodi khareedega. Usse waisi kuch khana khana hai usse toh. So they only are the patronizers of arts. So they are now at the misery of the British. Financially, they are ruined. So they are not able to keep up the demand for the artisans. So this is the whole impact of the Britishers. Ideas is there, geographical unity is there, communication system is there. Because of that, these effects are there and then economic misery is there. Got it? When Britishers came here, though yahan bhi jab wo aaye the na, they had a trade deficit only. Most of the things which they bought here, like modern utensils or those, wo hi chamak dhamak wali cheeze hi thi yahan par. Otherwise, most of the things they used to import from India only. Jaise spices ho gaye, right? And then what else? Yes, yes. Initially, it was the case, but later, hamare textiles bhi bahut achhi quality ke the. Yes. But later on, our products were expensive, so we were not able to compete. Similar is the case for oil seeds also. Edible oil, as we are importing, in 1991 we were self-sufficient in edible oils. Then what happened? Population. Population, no, it was for population. But free trade agreements, trade, FTAs we signed, so duty barriers were reduced. तो जितना भी ये साउथ ईस्ट का था दैट एडिबल ऑयल बिकेम चीप सो इफ द डिमांड इज रिड्यूस्ड ऑब्वियसली सप्लाई विल आल्सो रिड्यूस नाउ वी आर नेट इंपोर्टिंग कंट्री ऑफ एडिबल ऑयल्स तो ट्रेड बैलेंस शिफ्टेड इंडिया बिकेम फ्रॉम अ नेट एक्सपोर्टिंग कंट्री टू अ नेट इंपोर्टिंग कंट्री गॉट इट सो दिस इज द होल वी हैव नाउ रीच्ड टिल द इकोनॉमिक इंपैक्ट ऑफ द ब्रिटिशर्स Right, we started from their arrival in 1608 and we had reached till kaise kaise unhone kiya. Let's have a recap. Kahan se shuru karein? 1453 likhte hain, shabash. 1453, chalo. Next. 1498. Just keep on speaking. Kuch kuch jo aa raha hai, likho. 1608. Then, don't look at your notes. Just recall. Tension do dimag ko. Jitna tension mein aoge, utna sukhi rahoge. 1707, Aurangzeb. Okay, he remembers when he dies. Or kuch? Farman. Yeah, tell me some three bases. 1611, Maslipatnam is there on the east coast. 1668, 1639, Madras, Calcutta, जो भी है, बॉम्बे. Okay, next. फरमान आ गया. Problems have been created. 1757 and 1764, Buxar. 65, very good. Dual system. 73, Regulating Act. Pitts Act. 1813, Charter Act. Unique aspect is? Trade with India except tea. Chalo. Fir? Christian Mission is also very important point. 1833, total monopoly ended then? 1818, Anglo Maratha. Haan. Yahan aa jate hain. 1818, Anglo Maratha War. Anglo-Maratha War is important. Okay. Then? 1793. Revenue Settlement System. Cornwallis Revenue Settlement System. Achha, police wala bol rahe ho. Okay. Pulse. Then what you are saying? 1790? Subsidiary alliance system. Alright. What else? 1857. Abhi kiya nahi hai, dekh lenge. McCauley's Minute, okay. 1835, McCauley's Minute.
1853,
railways. Okay. Yes, law commission also. Law commission, civil services, railways. 54, telegraph and canal. 1857, Doctrine of Lapse was there only in 1830s only. Actually, Doctrine of Lapse was the part of the annexation system whereby if you don't have a successor, you don't have the right to adoption. So, but Dalhousie, who came in 1848, he implemented it in letter and spirit. So, uske baad wo highlight ho gaya. It was there in 1830 also. So, under Doctrine of Lapse, Jhansi ko kar liya annex. तभी फिर रानी लक्ष्मी बाई ही शी गेव दिस स्लोगन कि मैं अपनी झांसी नहीं दूंगी. ऑल राइट, व्हाट एल्स? और कुछ मिस कर रहे हैं? ऑल राइट, विल सी दैट लेटर ऑन. पोस्टल 1837, हाँ यहाँ हो गया. 1854 सिविल सर्विसेज फर्स्ट टाइम. 1837 पोस्टल, ठीक है.
सर 1800 फोर्ट विलियम.
यस, 1800 फोर्ट विलियम. 1806. ऑल राइट, सो दिस इज व्हाट वी हैव डन टुडे. सब कुछ एकदम रट्टा मार लो आग की तरह. रट्टा मार लो. आई एम टेलिंग यू अल्टीमेटली दिस इज द थिंग. यू हैव टू मेमोराइज एवरीथिंग. दैट इज अ इन बिटवीन एक्ट, बिलीव इट. नाउ हेयर आई एम टेलिंग यू द गेम इज नॉट के नाउ यू हैव 4.5 months एंड यू आर रीडिंग मॉडर्न इंडियन हिस्ट्री. बिपिन चंद्र से आप पढ़ रहे हो आराम से. इन द ओपन सेशन आई ऑल्सो आई टोल्ड यू कि वेन द लास्ट 10 days विल बी देयर एंड यू हैव टू रिवाइज एवरीथिंग. Everything will be piled up. That is the end game. So make such kind of revision system which makes your job easy. It should not make your job difficult. Ki teen kitabe padh rakhi hain, ab unko compile karna hai. That is not the work in the last 10 days. It should be done earlier. आखिरी के 10 दिन में सब पढ़ा होना चाहिए एकदम टेबल पे ही पूरी, जस्ट गो थ्रू देम, राइट? ओके, नाउ वी विल हैव अ टेस्ट, 20 मिनट टेस्ट, सम क्वेश्चंस विल बी देयर, आंसर इंडिविजुअली. ऑल आर डन, करें डिस्कस. चलो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चंस आर देयर, देखते हैं 22 के 22 किसके सही हैं. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, इंडियन रूलर्स टॉलरेटेड एंड एनकरेज एस्टेब्लिशमेंट ऑफ EIC, फलाना फलाना, ऑल दिस, सही है गलत है? इट इज करेक्ट. बैटल ऑफ प्लासी वॉज टर्निंग पॉइंट, एक्सपोर्ट्स टू ब्रिटेन इंक्रीज मैनीफोल्ड एंड एनकरेज इंडियन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एक्टिविटी, इट इज नॉट करेक्ट. रियल ब्लो टू हैंडीक्राफ्ट्स फेल आफ्टर द चार्टर एक्ट ऑफ 1813 when they lost not only their foreign markets but the markets in India itself. So what happened in 1813? All of sare shikari aage the wapas, all of them. Earlier only one shikari was there, East India Company, now all the shikaris are there. So answer is C. Here if you could just know that third is, three is wrong, or अच्छा टू पता होता गलत है तो हो जाता वैसे भी आंसर. देयर वाज सम. ऑलराइट, सेकंड, क्रोनोलॉजिकल ऑर्डर, पॉलिसी ऑफ इक्वल फेडरेशन, इट इज आफ्टर 1935, पॉलिसी ऑफ सबॉर्डिनेट यूनियन 1857 टू 1935, पॉलिसी ऑफ सबॉर्डिनेट आइसोलेशन, इट इज बेसिकली प्री 57 सबॉर्डिनेट आइसोलेशन. सबॉर्डिनेट आइसोलेशन मतलब सबॉर्डिनेट सब्सिडी अलायंस करके आइसोलेटेड रखना है, बफर स्टेट रखना है, लेकिन सबॉर्डिनेट रखना है. एंड सबॉर्डिनेट यूनियन मीन्स एवरीबडी इज इंटीग्रेटेड, फॉरेन पॉलिसी उनकी ले रखी है बट दे आर सबॉर्डिनेटेड. एंड इक्वल फेडरेशन आफ्टर 1935, प्रपोज्ड फेडरेशन इन 1935. सो आंसर इज डी, डी आंसर. वैसे इसमें लिखा नहीं है क्रोनोलॉजी में, पहले छोटा लिखना है या बाद में लिखना है, बट आंसर इज डी. All right, third question. Battle of Plassey, Indian exports to Britain increased sharply. We have to mark what is incorrect. Price of raw cotton in Bengal fell down drastically. ये सही होगा गलत होगा? Price बढ़ेगा ना cotton का? Cotton की तो demand बढ़ गई है. तो this statement is wrong. Indian textiles became cheaper in Britain, ये भी गलत है, because they had imposed taxes on our textiles which became costly in Britain. तो ये statement भी गलत है. Indian exports as a whole they increased, but imports decreased more than the exports, right? Exports increase हुए हैं क्योंकि raw cotton का बहुत बम्बास्टिक, क्योंकि सिर्फ इंडिया ही एक market नहीं है, और भी British Empire में बहुत सारी markets हैं. So this statement is correct. 2 and 3 are incorrect. So answer is C.
Sir, with regard to cotton prices, at the same time there was American Revolution going on in the US. America, US was also a great, large exporter of cotton. So at that time, cotton prices in India, it increased because their cotton exports fell down. But with regard to this question, it's asked with Battle of Plassey. So,
Anji, so American. American Revolution was 1776, you know? So there is a difference of timeline, but this is regarding 1757. In that regard, if you had asked, na, to ho sakta tha, right? Price of raw cotton fell down drastically, it is wrong. Cotton demand increase hui hai, toh price increase hua hai. Export of textiles went down, but overall exports they went up. All right, like of cotton. So, isme pucha hai Indian exports. The total head they are asking. Yes, now free trade is there, right? So that is reason, and basically cotton ka bahut bada role hai isme. All right, got it? What the question? First statement में Indian exports, it is not export of textiles only, So that is why it is correct. All right. Fourth question. Features of 1853, itna jaleel question hai ye. Open system, sahi hai. Ended commercial activity of EIC, when it ended? Huh? 1813, commercial activity ended? 1858. Company abolished in 1858, commercial activity. Commercial activity to chali na 1858 tak. Company is there till 1858. 1858 mein abolish hui hai company. Now it is under direct. In 18? Nahi, there was some commercial activities also there. Are company hai to commercial activity to hogi na. Monopoly is abolished. Right? But commercial activities is not abolished na. दूसरे लोग भी कर सकते हैं कमर्शियल एक्टिविटीज का मतलब थोड़ी कि उनकी कमर्शियल एक्टिविटी खत्म हो गई है दैट इज आफ्टर 1858 राइट ईआईसी को जो जो चार्टर मिला था कि इन इंडिया इन चाइना दैट इज योर एरिया ऑफ कंसर्न तो उन दोज एरियाज देयर मोनोपोली हैज बीन एंडेड बट मोनोपोली एंडेड मीन्स अदर्स कैन ऑल्सो ट्रेड डजंट मीन कि नाउ देयर एक्टिविटीज हैव बीन सस्पेंडेड All right. Yes. हाँ जी. A company खत्म हो गई ना फिर तो directly government ही बन गया वो. It became government. Yes. Yes. Right. Company पहले company rule कर रही है. If when we say कि Britishers ने हमें 200 साल तक rule किया, actually that has a technical angle. पहले company वाले loot रहे थे, बाद में directly they are looting, right? चलो. Fifth question. It separated the legislative and executive functions, yes. Now there are six additional members, right? Which C is the answer. Fourth ka answer is C. All right. Fifth question. 1773 Act. It paved way for establishment of Supreme Court in Calcutta. It had given British government effective and decisive control over the company. Effective decisive to 58 mein aega. Act resolved conflict between company and its opponents in India. Basically 1773 was what? Lobbying by done by some opponents ki bhai inko regulate karo. Alright, so they will not be satisfied. Because in 1773 only formal recognition is there. Yes, we are under the crown. Got it? So answer here is? B. B, one only. One only is right. We have to identify correct. Correct. It act resolved. Question is, did it resolve? What is their concern? They want their entry on also in Indian trade. That didn't happen. Unko regulation wa lekin monopoly to 1813 mein hua na. So conflict didn't resolve in 1773. Decisive control it didn't get. Na? Only a formal recognition is given of that, yes. Board of Control 1784. This is Regulating Act. And also in Board of Control, there are only two cabinet members. Chhe mein se. Toh decisive nahi keh sakte usse. All right. Haan, Vignesh?
There were actually a people were lobbying against the company and that's why the act came that yes, we are actually controlling
it. But what is the conflict? Conflict between company and its opponents. Opponents want, they also want to trade with India, na? So that conflict didn't resolve in 1773. It was only resolved in 1813 and later on 1833. Hanji.
When did the effective and decisive control come?
You tell. Aapko kya lagta hai? Decisive. Decisive matlab ab to hamare under aa gaya boss. 1858 only. Right? Got it? So answer here is B. Alright. Sixth. Company got the right to free trade. Battle of Plassey pe ek aur question hai. Free trade in Bengal, Bihar and Orissa. It's right. Achha, kuch alag hai kya ye? All right. Sixth is this question, I think. Subsidy reliance wala. The rulers of allying Indian state could negotiate the temporary stationing of British force within his territory and to pay a subsidy for its maintenance. We have to identify incorrect. They were not temporary forces, they were permanent forces. Indian ruler could not employ any European in service without the approval of Britishers. European nahi, koi aur Indian. European they could employ. Tha? Yes, other Europeans ke liye bhi tha. It was not only for Indians, for all other Europeans also, right? Kyunki inke interest kaise safeguard honge? They are fighting not only against the princes, but also against the other European powers also. Right? This is correct. Two is correct. ठीक है. Third, Indian rulers free to negotiate whether without. Obviously, it is wrong. So we have to identify one and three. C is the answer here. Right? Simple है यार ये तो एकदम बड़ा simple सा question था. All right. Question is now. Battle of Plassey. Company got right to free trade in Bengal, Bihar, and Orissa. French were no longer a significant power in Bengal. I didn't take the topic of French, Anji, but they were annihilated till, at least in Bengal. Yes, Vignesh, tell. Puch puch hai? Chal koi. Third, private trades of British merchants were still taxed. They were still taxed. British merchants were still taxed by the East India Company only. Right? Yes. They were not they were not taxed. They were taxed by the East India Company only. Right? So here correct answer is D. 1, 2 and 3. Seventh ka answer hai D. Eighth. Consider statement again, subsidiary lines started by Lord Wellesley. Year 1798. Hyderabad was accepted, yes, it is correct. Ruler lost the right to maintain diplomatic relations with other states, it is correct. Right? So answer here is D. Eighth is D. Ninth, judicial proceedings was Persian until Bentinck introduced some changes in language of court, it is correct. Bentinck in 1828 he came, and then until then Persian was the official language. Kitni harani ki baat hai, Persian thi, na Hindi, na Urdu, Persian. Kuch aur hi chal raha hai. So if you see your grandfathers and great grandfathers, many of them would be fluent in Urdu, Persian aati hogi unko. So this Persian was there, it was replaced by vernaculars in the local courts, and at the Supreme Court English was there. Ye Bentinck ne change introduce kiya tha. Law commission was set up under Macaulay, it is correct. Cornwallis was in favor of integration of justice and revenue dismiss, so he gave judicial power to district. It is correct. He advocated separation. Ye to ekdam hi galat hai. Combine kisne kiya tha? Bentinck ne aage kiya tha combine. All right, so if you know that 3 is wrong, agar aapko first 2 ka nahi bhi pata, then answer is C. See the options. Even if you know this basic fact ki who combined the power, who separated the power, you can solve this question. All right, 10th question. Regulating Act 1773, this is right, formal recognition was us there. 1784 mein Board of Control, then later on 1858, aapka crown aage directly. 1781 tried to address the ambiguities in the Act of 1770. I didn't take this one, isme kya tha, where very minor change was there, 1781. The Governor General was required to present the Supreme Court the rules he had framed. और अगर कुछ गलत से गलत होता था तो सुप्रीम कोर्ट कुड स्ट्राइक इट डाउन. तो इट इंट्रोड्यूस मेनी डिलेज. तो इस क्लॉज को रिमूव करने के लिए 1781 एक्ट आया था कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट के पास सब रूल नहीं पहुंचाने. ऑलराइट, तो दिस वाज 1781. बड़ी ट्रिवियल सा फैक्ट है. ऑलराइट, थर्ड, पिट्स इंडिया एक्ट वाज ग्रेटर ऑटोनॉमी फॉर ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी इन मैटर्स ऑफ पब्लिक एडमिन. ग्रेटर ऑटोनॉमी, ऑटोनॉमी इज बीइंग डिक्रीज्ड स्लोली एंड स्टेडली. तो थर्ड इज रॉन्ग. Third wrong karke B and C has been eliminated. But still we must know 2 is correct or wrong. So this question hinges on that trivial fact. Some questions will be such. So answer is A. 11th. Permanent settlement. Lord Cornwallis introduced permanent settlement of Bengal with the hope of rule of law and would bring in modernization in agriculture. It is correct. I told you na, their intention was such. ke the peasants will get stable returns and rights will be recognized. So maybe those kis mein? 10th is A. Yes, 1 and 2 is correct. So 11th mein, that was the intention. Ki the surplus will be plugged back into agriculture irrigation improve hoega. Permanent second stage mein, permanent settlement system criticized for not being innovative and being too similar to Mughal revenue settlement system. It is wrong. It is wrong. It was being said that you have changed a lot. You have land rights alienable. If you are not paying your rent properly, then your land can be sold off. Land has now become a private property after permanent settlement system. Alright, so it changed the whole system. That was the criticism, that you are changing too much. It is opposite of what is the fact. So answer is A. 11th answer is A. 12th, which among the following a part of Charter Act 1813? Dasso bhi. 4th to sahi hai hi hai. End of trade monopoly of British with India. Yeah, it's thoda sa vague lag raha hai. But given the options, it is the best fit. Because third statement specifically says ki monopoly of tea trade. So obviously the first statement means except for tree. So answer is 1 and 4. C. 12th is C. 13th. C. 12th ka C hai. China ke saath 33. 13th. Kaun bola? Okay. 13th. Railways, it led to promotion of Indian rural. Funded mainly by Indian investors? No. British investors. Basically what happened ke at the time of Industrial Revolution, saturation happened in steel industry. Wahan to sab ban chuka hai. 1814-18 mein railways ban chuki hai. Whole expansion is there. But in India, if the steel manufacturers promoted railways, they would be getting 4 to 5% return. Aur wahan mil raha tha 1.5 to 2%. So that was the motive why they promoted railways in India. Steel manufacturers, they wanted bumper profits, right? So mainly funded by British investors. So it is wrong. So neither. D is the answer for 13th. 14th, according to Zamindari, yeah, Zamindari, first statement, Zamindari, peasant is wrong. Second, wrong. Third, correct. So answer is A. Next, Lord Wellesley, temporary hai toh phir galat ho gaya. Allowed interfere in? Black hole. What is the statement? Read it out. Peasants didn't retain ownership of land. It was the zamindars. Hana ekdam statement ko pure acche se padho. Badi si statement di hogi, last mein some twist will be there. Hum sochenge yaar ye sahi hai, sahi hai, sahi hai. Correct. Last mein twist ho jayega. Alright, like in polity they used to give some twist ke for amendment under Article 368. It needs ratification of this majority and more than half of the Indian states. Change kar diya na last mein. Aise ho jati galtiyan. Land ownership vested with village committees. That is wrong. Land ownership vested with rayots. Village communities, mahalwari ka system. Alright. So, aap focus kar rahe ho directly collected revenue from peasants. That is correct. But galat kahin aur hai statement. Ana? Read statement carefully. Alright. Ye black hole incident. Alright. A simple sa hai to. Simple bhi aayenge UPSC mein. Chhodna mat unhe. Alright. Next question. Subsidiary alliance. All three are correct. Temporary stationing of British. Permanent hai bhai sahab. They allowed to interfere in internal affairs of the allied state. No. They got under the alliance system, it was ke we will not interfere. Though practically they interfered. Haanji, puchho Vignesh. They allowed to interfere in the internal affairs of the allied state. under subsidy line system, they said that we will station a British agent and we will not interfere in your internal affairs. Only in your external affairs, foreign policy, we will interfere. That's a different thing, that they didn't do it. They acted against this agreement. But under the alliance system, this was the arrangement. All right. Right to... अरे थर्ड स्टेटमेंट तो पढ़ लो, आंसर पे पहले पहुंच जाते हो. रीड द स्टेटमेंट. अलाइड स्टेट वुड नॉट नेगोशिएट विद एनी विदाउट दी. ठीक है, दैट इज करेक्ट. सो आंसर इज बी. आंसर इज बी, ओनली थर्ड इज करेक्ट. फर्स्ट एंड फर्स्ट टू आर रॉन्ग. जिसने भी क्वेश्चन बनाया अच्छे बनाए. विद रेफरेंस टू ड्यूअल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन 1765, नवाब हैड द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन विदाउट पावर. क्या हो रही है? अच्छा ये आ जाओ. चलो हाँ भी दसो की है. सेवनटीन्थ लॉर्ड कैनिंग का पता है 1861. ये तो कवर भी नहीं किया अभी. क्वेश्चन आ गया लेकिन, बट व्हाट टू डू, वी हैव टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन. लेट्स सी. फर्स्ट इज करेक्ट. इफ फर्स्ट इज रॉन्ग देन डायरेक्टली आंसर इज सी. दो वी डोंट नो कि थर्ड इज करेक्ट और नॉट, बट वी हैव फाउंड द आंसर राइट. Here Cornwallis was adopted, Hastings was there, but under Pitt's India Act, Cornwallis ko next banana tha. So here Hastings is there, not Lord Wellesley. 18th, haan, 18th pata ho, dual system. First is correct, first is correct. Second, appointment is in the hand of the Britishers. Appointment in the is the hand. सेकेंड इज रॉन्ग. यस सेकेंड इज रॉन्ग. अपॉइंटमेंट्स उनके हाथ में, जो भी मेजर काम होगा वो सब उनके हाथ में, डिप्टी सूबेदार है सब. बट जो डे टू डे वर्क है दैट विल बी द टास्क ऑफ द नवाब. ओके नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. हाँ 18 सेकेंड पार्ट देखो. अपॉइंटमेंट्स ऑफ ऑल द इंपॉर्टेंट इंस्टीट्यूशंस दैट विल बी अंडर द ब्रिटिश British prerogative. But जो day to day laborious mundane work है, जो आप civil servant बन के करोगे, that is the prerogative of the Nawab. Appointment is not his prerogative. Everything which will be related to exercise of some power, that will be not under Nawab. चलो next. Answer is A. Next question number क्या है बता दो जरा. यहाँ उल्टा पुल्टा हो गया सब. 19th. फरमान पे question है. First is correct. Lower rate or zero rate? Zero rate. It is zero rate, not lower rate. So first is wrong. Second? Second is wrong. Unse thodi 10 tak. Right? Indian merchants, they couldn't tax 10. Though that they did after Siraj-ud-Daulah jab ban gaya. But that was not their prerogative. So second is also wrong. Answer is D. 17th, tuchcha question hai ekdam. Answer batao kisne iska galat kiya. Who was A? बोर्ड ऑफ कंट्रोल कब आया था? इट इज सेइंग प्रायर टू रेगुलेटिंग एक्ट्स. कोर्ट ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स, कंपनी के कोर्ट ऑफ डायरेक्टर्स. तो आंसर इज बी. नेक्स्ट. फर्स्ट इज करेक्ट. न्यू रेवेन्यू कस्टमरी राइट्स उनके ले लिए. मेड लैंड एलियनेबल, इट कैन बी सोल्ड इफ यू नॉट, इफ यू डू नॉट पे योर रेंट्स. मेन फैक्टर है डी इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन. व्हाट इज दिस? कुछ भी रैंडम घोस दिया अंदर. लार्ज स्केल इन्वेस्टमेंट इन लैंड इट लेट टू नो. तो आंसर इज ए. ओके नेक्स्ट. हो गया सारा? लास्ट क्वेश्चन. हाँ बताओ इसका क्या है. ऑल थ्री, ऑल फोर. ऑल फोर तो ऑप्शन भी नहीं है. वन इज करेक्ट. वन इज करेक्ट. टू free, one-sided free trade initiated by 1773. When was free trade initiated? 1813, boss. 1813, free trade. 1833 for every product, including tea. But mainly in 1813. Here it is saying 1773. Achha, aur batao. Third statement. Indigo and tea decreased. It will increase. And four. Gradual decline of Indian, it is correct. So answer is D, 1 and 4. All done? चलो बताओ 22 किसके सही हैं? 22 ऑल करेक्ट. हु इज द किंग और द क्वीन? नो वन. चलो 22 to 20 वन. ट्वेंटी से लेके 15 चलो 10 से 15 लोग हैं. 15 to 10 All right, here also 10 से 15 लोग हैं. 10 से नीचे वाले भाई साहब सतर्क हो जाओ. बी वेरी केयरफुल बट डोंट वरी. If you want to fail, fail in the preparation rather than failing in the big exam. The more you sweat in training, the less you will bleed in battle. Okay? So, tomorrow we'll cover social religious reforms. Any questions?